We should be good to go. Man says Fortnite wins the game of the year. We are here with the Game Awards 2021 edition. Let me switch the screen. Bam. 2021 Game Awards. Hopefully it's good this year and it doesn't suck terribly. If you enjoy this, be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. We're going to see who is going to win. We've got some good contenders this year. It'd be great to see something about Persona 6, but I think it's just going to be, hey, Persona 3 port. There you go. Also, I have a special guest here with me. Good old Rez themselves. Rez, say hello.
Hello, you boy.
So yeah, that's who we are here with. You said we all know it's going to be hot dog water. We're just here for the trailers. I mean, yeah. I mean, I don't care much about like what game wins what award. I'm really here for the trailers too. You said Rez is drunk, isn't he? I mean, you should have heard Rez earlier. He was doing all types of voices. It was something to say the least. But yeah, we've got a... Oh god. We've got a minute to go, and so the Game Awards officially... Well, they start their... They start up, and they're gonna have 10 announcements they're doing first within this 30-minute span. 10 world premieres. And then from there, we get into the big boy stuff after that. So sit back, relax, get some snacks, and we're gonna have a good time. But what's up, Ramsey? What's up, Relax? What's up, Drake? What's up, Dino? What's up, Potato? What's up, Rachel? What's up, Blazing? How y'all doing? I think I did a good job of that. And thank you guys very much for the 10 likes on the stream. Greatly appreciate it, as always. Game Awards is just a fancy Nintendo Direct State of Play, to be honest. Yeah, and if Microsoft decides to do anything, I think they are, then boom. Sounded like Corey X Kenshin. Oh, the homie Corey. That dude is legendary. Alright, let's pause the music. And here we go. Let me do this. Are y'all ready? Chat, I just realized I need to move you guys. Oh my god. The following program may contain stuff that's gonna make you be traumatized for the rest of your life. Like Persona 6.
Viewer discretion advised!
Yes, the Ubisoft stream starts now.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to the 2021 Game Awards pre-show. It's a show for all you completionists out there that rewards you with exclusive content, awards, and not to be missed, or you'll embarrass yourself, world premieres. I'm Sydney Goodman, and as you can see, I am in person at the iconic Microsoft Theater to hype you up for gaming's biggest night. We are live streaming around the real world and in the virtual world, thanks to Horizon Venues with Oculus. Our main show starts soon and includes massive musical performances, Suicide Squad, The Matrix Awakens, and Destiny 2. But if there's one thing this community knows, it's that you don't have to hail from a giant studio to make your mark in gaming. Let's start off strong with our first world premiere.
An indie action
adventure that is as charming as its hero is cunning. This is Tunic.
Listen, I know for these first few world premieres, like, I mean, until the official thing starts, they're going to show us some indie games. So hopefully it's some good looking indie games. And what is this?
Wow. It's a furry game.
Oh my lord. Oh my god. I could probably just keep this lower for the time being. Oh my god. How you doing, Scarlet? And gotcha, relax, gotcha, Dino. Have a good time enjoying this show also.
Reminds me of the Link.
Yeah, Link's Awakening?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That one.
It looks cute. Would I play it? Probably not. But it looks cute. You said animal equals furry? 2021 logic. Listen, I think this is a Legend of Zelda ripoff. I'm gonna have to call my rep at Nintendo. Yeah, did you get a load of this game? Yeah, it looks just like Link's Awakening. They called it Tunic.
Tunic.
It's an Xbox game. Yeah. Tunic, like Link's Tunic? I don't know. I'm sort of suspicious. Okay. All right, yeah, they're gonna sue.
And now It's time for the very first award of the evening, and I really can't think of a better one to start us off.
Okay.
Games for Impact. This category highlights the very best of what gaming can be. Thought-provoking stories that challenge the player on more than just skill, exploring all the corners of the human condition. These are the games that remind us, in a medium where you can be anything, be good, or at least chaotic neutral. Here are the nominees of the Games for Impact Award.
Life is Strange is probably going to win.
And the Game Award for Games for Impact.
Life is Strange.
Life is Strange.
True Colors.
Wow. That was surprising.
Thank you so much. I can't believe we won.
What do you mean? Your life is strange. What do you mean you can't believe you won?
With the world, and by the time we do, the world's often different from when we started the adventure. That's never been more true for me than with Life is Strange True Colors. It's not just about finishing a game in quarantine. Who could have predicted what kind of an impact a game about human connection would make in 2021? So from everyone at Deck Nine and our partners at Square Enix, thank you so much.
Okay, I mean, yeah, I played like the first Life is Strange and it was really good, but I never played like the other stuff after that.
Now, before we take a quick break, I have to tell you about Luna, Amazon's cloud gaming service that turns your TV into a gaming console.
No, stay on my screen.
Now,
please, don't leave me.
Amazon,
don't leave me.
They're a little indie development studio.
Cindy, don't
I'm
leave
kidding.
Me.
Anyway, now for a limited time, hey, the Fire TV gaming bundle is $40 off. The bundle
I don't want
Fire
that
TV
Amazon
stick,
gaming.
4K Max,
stay with
and
me.
Luna controller,
stay with me.
A high-performance controller built
It's about dry.
Luna.
It's about
Get it now at Amazon.com.
If The Rock pulls up during this thing, I will sing
Game Awards pre-show
the whole part
this.
Of Rock's verse. I will sing his whole verse.
Hey, Game Awards, I'm Nate Hill.
Who?
Hey, I'm Aaron
I know who you are.
We'll be watching the Game Awards.
Yeah, I know who Nate Hill is. Back when I used to watch Fortnite streamers.
Party, party until we can't hardly party. And there's gonna be some surprise.
He looks like Midas from Fortnite.
I think one of their names is Jack Harlow, yeah?
I think one, yeah. One
oh, he does.
Harlow. Yeah. Jack Harlow.
The reason why we're just talking through this is we do not care. I'm gonna be honest. Is he self-promoting? What do you do? What is this free self-promotion? I can't believe this. This is what the Game Awards pre-show is now? People just self-promoting their channels? Put me on there. They didn't invite me to the Game Awards. They didn't even give me my badge. So, you know, chat, the Game Awards, they're actually mailing me a badge that I was supposed to be able to wear, you know. It's going to be very nice, but it's not getting here in time. So, you know, it is what it is. You said The Rock should show up in the Fortnite fit? That'd be hype. And then he does, like, if The Rock did his performance while in the Fortnite outfit, I'd be done. I would be so done, dude.
Yes.
They don't invite Goombas? Okay. Okay. Give me 2 years. I bet you they'll invite me to the Game Awards. Give me 2 years.
Chosen by the gods for this very moment. To cut this giant problem down to size. No pressure.
I would never want to be on the Game Awards stage, though. Oh my god, I'd have a panic attack. I'd be like, in the game of the year. I'd be freaking stuttering
in the work now.
I'd say the game of the year. I'd end up saying like Animal Crossing or something. I'd say some random game. You said if Monster Hunter wins RPG, you gotta fight two Rajong off stream. Oh hell. Are you talking about your?
Do it.
Oh, you're saying the spelling? Yeah. See, thank you, Rachel. How you doing?
Hey, everyone, and welcome
Hello, ma'am.
Back. We are so happy to have you with us, whether you're in person or watching the stream.
I didn't get my invite.
We polled Reddit's r/gaming community to see what their pick is for 2021's Game of the Year, and the winner is Resident Evil Village. And if you're on TikTok, use the hashtag Game Night to celebrate the Game Awards. We are getting closer to the big show, and people are showing up early because the early birds get the worm, and they know better than to miss out on three of the biggest world premieres in gaming that we are about to see.
What?
Roll the thing.
What are you showing me? You're making it seem like it's a big deal. Oh, this is hype.
Oh, King of Fighters.
Show me some good. Who are you? I don't know a lot of King of Fighter characters.
Once the hour is too late,
I'm gonna get this music. Second open beta test. Nice. Okay. Yeah, I played the beta and I played a Shermie and I got bodied online. That's what happened. But the music's very good in the game. Why won't the stream go up in quality? Whose arms are the... Are you talking about the our stream? Is it not? I mean, I'll check.
Get ready for a fight.
Get ready for a freaking fight.
Is this Pokemon?
No, it has the options for me, Scarlet, for it to go up. I guess it must be something going on with you over there. Is this Pokemon? What is this? A game based on true events. Are you fixed it?
Oh, okay. No, it's not.
Yes, a game based on true events. Pokemon Arceus Legends, or whatever it is. Run this up. I feel like it's meant to be this low right now. Oh my gosh. They were cooking people. They were putting them in the food. Oh my gosh.
Ooh! Fresh meat.
What? Oh, okay. Oh my god. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. A horror multiplayer horror game based on true events, so it's gonna be like Friday the 13th. Wait, so there was a person that was just killing people with chainsaws in real life?
I have no idea.
That was a thing?
I remember the Cartoba. An island in a dune sea.
Dune?
Oh my god. I remember the Guidestone. The Diamond Shoals. The Sisters of Balcora. Spinning 100 billion stars. The song of the core.
What is this? And yeah, it was a thing. Now what's up, cat? Oh my god. A spaceship. We're Shin Megami Tensei 6 shaking my head. I know, right? The vegan teacher right now, chat. tell Rez the desert people are on the way.
I know the reference.
You know what he's talking about? I have no idea what he's
talking
about.
Yeah, I was talking about the movie.
Oh, and Dune.
Yeah, Dune.
Okay, I still haven't seen it, but I know y'all were having a good time talking about that.
It's just too funny and weird.
I'll take your word for it. But not really, he's based loosely off of Ed Jin.
Was it so long ago? No, not so long.
Wow.
But not long enough.
Hey, it's a wife.
It's Zero Suit Samus. Oh my god. Ed Gein. Okay. I got you. Well, we've got 18 minutes until the big boy show starts. They still have like more smaller announcements.
And now I have the honor of announcing the winners for 4 esports categories.
I won. I am the esports champion. I won Evo.
And the game award goes
I won.
To Simple.
Why isn't it?
I won Evo. I won Evo. I'm trying to. I don't remember any other tourney names. Rez, give me some tourney names.
And the game award goes to Nadis Vincere. Congratulations, Navi.
Rez, do you know any other gaming gaming competitions?
I don't know.
I won.
And the game award goes to Koma.
You said, I wonder if SNK is showing a trailer here. You just missed a KOF trailer.
Here are the
actually.
Nominees. And the game award League of goes Legend. To 2021
League but yeah, you I just missed it. The King World of Fighters thing. They announced the second beta. I don't know if it had a date or not, but I don't know if they showed the date. I feel like I would have remembered.
And now we have 3 more world premieres in a row ready for you, spanning all different genres and niches. niches. And to start us off, rising from the ashes to take their rightful place as gaming royalty once again, Telltale Games is back and better than ever, and I cannot wait for you to see.
Wait, is it Wolf Among Us 2? Is it time? Oh my god, I've been waiting like 7-8 years. Please be Wolf Among Us.
Stories about you. I know you've been a rock hopper, so you survived the crushing black of space. You work the docks on Ceres, so you don't put up with any bullshit. You were Dawes' attack dog, so you don't have any problems killing inners or belters who disagree with the OPA.
Is Star Wars?
I've heard quite a bit about you, Kamina Drummer. It's hard to tell if it's all
true. It looks like Star Wars.
Truth is truth. How you deal with it is up to you, Boss Mang.
I turned out the
Telltale's coming. I mean, Telltale's getting their own, you know, their own stuff, you know, there's original stuff.
From Amazon's hit show, The Expanse.
Ma'am, I'm not. And I'm okay, to be so, Check it's out like the Sega incident. Listen, the Wolf Among Us Season 2 has to show up at some point. You said I look so bored? No, I was in pain right there. I mean, right now we're still in the pre-show before the official award show starts. But, yeah, I was hoping for the Wolf Among Us Season 2. Because we've been waiting like 8 years or something. So, yeah, that wasn't it, so it caused a lot of pain. I amped myself up for nothing. What is this? Platinum Games? Okay. Your bond with the Gideon Coffin gives you strength. Oh, this is that fancy game we saw, right? Like that everybody looks super fancy in it, but the gameplay looks sort of interesting, right?
Control. The only thing you can't do. Let's go back.
I see. All right. Listen, chat, I gotta ask you. Tonight, what do you think wins Game of the Year? There's Psychonauts 2, there's Deathloop, there's freaking Metroid Dread, there's Ratchet & Clank, there's Resident Evil, and then I'm forgetting one game. I'm not gonna lie, there's one game that I forgot that's nominated up there. But yeah. I think it goes to Resident Evil, Ratchet & Clank, or Metroid Dread. That's what I think. I'd be surprised if it went to the other three. You said Ratchet & Clank, but you doubt it. And Resident Evil is the only one you recognize. What is this? Indie game? Between Ratchet & Clank? And Resident Evil, but you're guessing Resident Evil? My prediction is that Resident Evil wins. I think that will be the one that wins, because we know why. You said, isn't Cyberpunk 2077? They didn't put it up. I mean, it was eligible for nomination. They just didn't put it up for nomination. Because,
Free weekend. Play now.
Because of the, you know, bad press. So, yeah, that's why I didn't go up there.
Hey, Vo, you should play this game.
What? What the heck is this, bro? yeah, let me play as the pig. Let me play as the pig.
Defy the Iron Fist!
But yeah, if I was to, like, say a game that would get the majority of people's votes, I think it goes to Resident Evil. Just off of the popularity factor. You said this feels so weird, dude. You're usually at a VC watching the Game Awards. It's different this year, eh? New
Look
Garfield.
At that.
Oh my gosh, this looks so funny. Fun.
I have something for you.
Oh my god. Yeah, I'm gonna do that to you.
What's up, everybody? I am Ariel Sowers, and I'm at the Game Awards. Let me take you on a tour. That's the stage right there, and this is the back of it. That's pretty much it. We'll be hanging out with myself and Nate Hill tonight on his Twitch channel. Make sure you.
Whoa, no. This lady trying to self promote again. She's trying to self promote. Man, get out of here. Nah, we can't listen to that. She's promoting a Twitch channel. We don't go to Twitch, okay?
All right.
That's what I have. Two more world premieres for you coming in steaming hot, fresh from the oven. Let's take a look.
All right, let's see what we're dealing with. Makes you so sad that people love Resident Evil, but it's hard for you to find people who even heard
of it. Oh, Monster Hunter.
Silver light illuminates the land and the new monster. New monster?
Yeah. New monster.
Do I have a reason to finally go back to this game? They said, hey, we know you're complaining about not getting a new expansion until the summer next year. We're going to give you a monster right now. Wintertime. Give it to me. Give it to me, Monster Hunter, please. Who is she? Who is she?
She's a sword and shield user.
It's the DLC.
We shall be in port soon.
It's the DLC.
This is
the summer DLC. We got bamboozled. Ha 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 ha. They said you thought, dude, you wait until the summer.
Oh my god.
You know, I've already been hurt twice in this pre-show. And the official thing hasn't even started yet.
You've been reckless with other people's hearts for so long.
Look at that.
It was a matter of time before you wrecked your own. Morning, Ma. Wow, Jala.
Hi, Auntie.
You pissed off your exes so much, they organized against you.
Are we flirting? Or are we fighting?
Come closer and find out.
What in the Bollywood movie am I looking at? You just get the chunk like club, bro? Okay. I don't even know what I'm looking
at. Is this a fighting game, skateboard, or?
Damn, okay, bro. She doing all that twirling just to cook. The power of friendship. Too strong.
Rather your axes disappoint
your
parents.
Thirsty suitors?
Coming soon. Patience.
Okay.
Evil Dead the Game at the Game Awards. And tomorrow on Twitch's Winter Gathering, Jeff Keighley will chat with Bruce Campbell himself and Saber's Tim Willits about the game, which is coming out next year.
Okay.
And now we've got the world gameplay premiere of another evil game, Evil West, which we also announced last year at the Game Awards. Let's take a look.
This is going to be my face all night.
You know what kept me alive all these years?
Upkeep,
maintenance.
I remember a trailer for this. Course, we didn't see gameplay, right? Now we're gonna see gameplay.
Hell's gates start spewing shit everywhere.
Okay, wait a sec. Damn, I get to play as Aaron Black from Mortal Kombat. He got his own game.
That's actually pretty. Whoops.
Yeah, it doesn't look bad. So far. What the hell?
It's like a combination of Doom guy and Cowboy guy.
This actually looks fun. Is it co-op?
Ooh, you didn't see
Evil
that.
Evil West.
Okay. I like what I saw from that.
But I am greedy for more content. Here's a new world premiere from Perfect Worlds.
Doomguy McCree and Dark Souls. There you go. No, and Aaron Black, I'd say.
Ah, good morning, Death. What a lovely day to be alive, wouldn't you say? Ready for another busy week in the afterlife? Oh my, busy may have been an understatement. Evidently, your sorrows have been working overtime. Oh my, really? Wow, that is truly unprofessional. Now, Death, we talked about this. Try not to lose your temper again.
Oh, what?
Maybe it's about time your subordinate showed you some respect. Well, you know what they say. If you want things done right, it's best to do them yourself.
Oh, okay. Fast-paced.
I like the animation style.
That's nice. Okay.
Nice music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the presentation for this is very well done. Have a nice death. March 2022, early access. Okay. Oh my god! I've seen this lady like three times. Three times I've seen you.
Blah, hey
guys,
blah, blah,
come
blah,
check
blah.
Out my Twitch channel, you know what I'm saying, you know.
Sub to the, you know, Special K Experience.
You know, come check out my Twitch, you know. You know, we don't even really know each other.
Oh, I have the pleasure of presenting the Game Award for Best Audio Design. When your medium relies so heavily on being successful in putting the player inside your story, audio design is everything. It's the ultimate hint system, an instant mood that either alerts the player to what's coming next or obscures it. It's basically playing God. Here are the nominees for Best Audio Design.
Ooh.
And the Game Award
Resident
for
Evil
Best Audio Design goes
Resident
to...
Resident Evil.
Forza Horizon 5.
What?
Hey, yeah, thank you so much. Our audio team throughout the development of Forza Horizon 5 have just been so passionate about everything that they do. There's this relentless appetite to produce an audio experience of the absolute highest quality. This award, it really does mean the world to us. I'm gonna say a few thanks if that's okay. So, Fraser, Matt, and Rich, guys, you did it, this is for you.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Forza Horizon 5. And now we have an incredible composer, Takeshi Furukawa, here to tell us more about his latest score. Let's check it out.
Here we go.
Hi, everyone. I'm Takeshi Furukawa. You might have heard my music. I am most known for my BAFTA-nominated score for The Last Guardian. Several years ago, I met with a new and exciting Swedish studio who shared with me their vision for a beautiful sci-fi story. The game centers around a heartfelt relationship between a young girl and an adorable creature. I instantly fell in love with the project and its stunning visuals. Here's a taste of the game with the original soundtrack I'm working on right now. I hope you enjoy it.
It better be good.
Wishfully. Got 4 minutes till the big boy show starts. Boy. Let's see what we got here. About to hit me with some good music. Ah, yes, it's high noon. The Last Guardian was pretty good, to be honest. I never played it. What the heck is that? He said I should put Drake in the VC. He'd be screaming. He I saw the message he put. He would have been screaming because they didn't give him Monster Hunter. They didn't make it come out earlier.
Why do like Mike? Spider creep.
Listen, we got 3 minutes. 3 minutes, come.
Like this entire place has spider creatures.
Oh my god, it's the things from Star Wars. Oh shoot.
Look, there's so many spider creatures.
Bruh, she's gonna be a Jedi, man. What's up, Nano? How you doing? Yeah, she gonna be a Jedi, man. Just you wait. Planet of Lana.
No, planet of spiders.
Yeah. You said a sleeping slang for something you're too female to understand? No. That has nothing to do with whether you're a female or not. No. That means, like, sleeping. Like, you're asleep. Like, you're knocked out. Yeah, that's what that means. Like, if I was to fall over on my chair and over-exaggerate like I'm sleeping, that's what that'd be. Yeah, Scarlett, I don't know. You might be too female to know what that means, apparently.
Apparently. Here it is. I can't believe it. We are already here. We are down to our final world premiere of our pre-show.
Hurry.
It is a special game announcement. Something you did not see coming.
I didn't see coming. What is it? Persona 3? Remake?
Oh, is it?
Oh, please! Hello, the Game Awards! I come bearing news! Ever wonder what happened after Persona 4 Golden? Now you can check out Persona 4 Arena Ultimax and find out! I can barely wait to show you how everybody's doing!
That's actually pretty hype, though. So we get the Persona 4 fighting game? Okay! I'll buy this. I'll take it. It wasn't quite what I thought I was gonna get, but I'll take it. That's actually pretty hard.
I mean, I could have accepted Persona 5 or anything. That's a lot.
March 17th. It's gonna be on the Switch? Not Xbox.
The Steam pre-order will be available very soon. Oh, how steamy.
Freaking hate you,
okay,
Teddy.
Everyone, I hate you, Teddy. It's time for me to hand it off to our main show. I hate to say goodbye,
oh, I know you did,
but
Drake.
I think I've earned a chance to chill out and have my mind blown with incredible awards and exciting artists, performances by Sting and Imagine Dragons.
Sting! You heard that,
Keanu
Drake
Reeves,
and Ramsey.
Carrie
Sting's
Boss,
gonna be here. Oh,
Jim
my God.
Carrey, Ben Schwartz, and yes, more world premieres.
But yeah, I'll take Persona 4
so
Ultimate. Okay.
Our main show.
I mean, I never got to play
and
the game.
I just
game.
Want to say, I hope
gonna
I didn't get too
there.
Bad
hey, Bo,
about how many world premieres we had, but you know what? I'm not going to apologize, because when the best of the best of game development and production has that much to share, I think we all win. And when it comes to the Game Awards, more is more, baby. Thank you all for getting stoked with me at the pre-show, and congratulations to the winners of our first awards of the night. And that's it for me. I'm Sydney Goodman. I'm going to go find my seat. The 2021 Game Awards starts now.
Let's go, baby. Let's get it. Let's get it.
Show us.
What's up, RS? You made it just in time.
Welcome, welcome. I am the monster.
This better not be a damn copyrighted song.
You ripped out all my parts. And worst of all, for me to live, I got
I mean,
go
keep talking.
Part of me
yeah.
That I needed you more.
So it doesn't get a copyright.
I hope you know.
Damn, this dude, he looks like he been through some stuff. You look hella sad, man.
I want you to hurt like you hurt.
Yeah. You said you could sing better than this too. Are you sure about that? Dino, I don't know if I want to hear you sing, man. I don't know about that one, chief. What could have been? Damn. I don't know, is this copyright? Is this a song from a video game, or is this a song that's actually copyrighted? Does anybody even recognize this song? Has anybody ever heard this before?
Nah.
Keep going.
No.
That's beautiful. He's still going.
You sing.
Oh.
You ripped out all my parts.
Yeah, okay, apparently they ripped out all of his parts. That sounds really painful.
Do you hear me sing?
Beautiful. Let's see what he's saying again. It's so beautiful, so beautiful. Okay. You took his lover?
Violin noises.
Violin solo. Go off.
They
can't copyright me off a violin. Once he starts singing, just take him out of it. Violin solo going crazy. Go crazy.
Damn, man. Next Mozart.
Beautiful. Okay, stop singing. All right, you said sing. I'm not doing no screamo.
The blue.
Just sing like you're constipated.
And I say to myself, what a wonderful world. Beautiful, beautiful.
Ready, room.
Do you want me to say the N-word?
No, the Shaggy too. Got a violin solo. I want you to do what you do. Waiting for this to stop. When it keeps on going, do. If for whatever reason they show Kirby gameplay, you won't have a voice tomorrow. Oh, yeah,
okay,
for sure.
Okay.
He's done?
He's done.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You right there. Thank you. You over there. I don't like you. Okay. I did a pretty good job there, didn't I? No. Light work, chat.
Are you not afraid of the future? With all of its unknowns.
Why don't we just go ahead and tell her that we're divorcing?
My daughter is not a weapon.
Take him away.
The She's an emergency.
The free-thinking world is in your hands.
Oh my god.
I know you've
been the Rock's gonna pull
my...
back.
It's not what you think, Matt.
I'm telling you, the Rock's gonna pull up tonight, man. He's gonna do a performance.
Give me life and to death.
Oh, no. I sense suffering here, Spirit.
Oh my god.
You have to work on it. You can't just give up.
You can't just give
We're
up.
Never getting out of
You've
here.
Got to work on
Let's
it.
Let's see how oh boy. Special.
You dislike this video confirmed. Oh my god. Yeah, I mean.
To a life of solitude.
Hey, Tails of Arise.
Yeah. Oh, it's the mean guy. Look at him.
It will not be fine. It will be.
I heard that game was good though.
I guess it's my time to shine.
Oh my god, it's Metroid PTSD.
God gives victory to the lions. When I look
the
into
Lion
your
King.
Eyes, I see lions.
I never
Sorry,
freeze.
Could you repeat that?
Oh boy.
After him.
Ah, yes, Dr. Nefarious.
Do you feel it?
Yes.
You yeah, you got a big forehead.
Enjoy the beach.
Oh my god.
One revolution was enough.
Oh, boy.
Ah, Shin Megami.
I saw Genshin flash in there for like a second. I saw La Senora for a split
Welcome
second.
Welcome to the Game Awards 2021. Now, here's your host. Jeff Keighley.
Jeff, you did an upgrade. This year, you don't have on them tight pants.
Hello, everybody.
Last year, you had some tight pants on. What?
We're here. We made it. Hello, everyone. I'm Jeff Keighley, and this is the Game Awards, video games' biggest night, live in person. It's amazing. First of all, wasn't Sting phenomenal?
Wait, that's
so
that was Sting.
Open our show. That
oh,
was what
damn.
Have been from Arcane, the new Netflix series based on League of Legends. Thank you so much, Sting, Ray Chen, and the Game Awards
I thought
Orchestra.
I thought it was wrestling Sting.
That
damn.
Was absolutely incredible. Thank
bamboozled.
You guys. Well, I gotta say, it feels so incredible
Shang-Chi.
To be back here on stage
oh,
at Microsoft Theater,
cool, right?
Streaming live to tens of millions of
Wait
people.
Wait a second, Shang-Chi wasn't wearing his mask.
This is
Everybody else gotta wear their masks, and you know, the Shang-Chi got them powers.
Are nothing without amazing developers, and that's why we do this show, to honor the creators of games.
Yes,
so welcome to all of you guys here today.
Listen, chat, I know you saw Shang-Chi wasn't wearing that mask. What's going on? Anybody else?
So
hey, that guy isn't back there either.
You know, I'll be on him all night. Real, and we can't ignore the headlines that are out there. Game creators need to be supported by the companies that employ them.
Uh-oh. He talking about Activision.
So let me just say this before we get to any of the news or announcements or awards. We should not and will not tolerate any abuse, harassment, and predatory practices by anyone, including our online communities.
I'm talking about Activision. Blizzard.
We all love games, and if we want this industry to keep growing, we must build an even brighter and more inclusive future. The games we play, and when the games that we love, they teach us that we can impact the world around us. And tonight, I call on everyone to do their part to build a better, safer video game industry. Speak out online. Vote with your time and with your dollars. Empower these world builders who are creating the future of all entertainment. And believe me, the future you're about to see looks absolutely incredible. We got a lot of good stuff for you. We have so much news to get to. But now, to present tonight's first award, please welcome a nominee tonight and the star of Far Cry 6, the one and only Giancarlo Esposito!
Oh my god, it's meme guy!
Oh god.
Holy crap.
He's gonna be a meme.
Do the face.
Game Awards.
Independence allows a game to go a little bit more wild, become a bit stranger, and the freedom to break boundaries. Tonight's radically creative nominees for Best Independent Game demonstrate excellence achieved through great risk. Here are the nominees for Best Independent Game.
Ah, yeah. What do we got here?
Best Independent Game.
Look, I know.
Ooh, 12 minutes is probably gonna win.
Oh, that was a
already.
Good game.
Yeah, I saw 12 minutes. Very, very good game. Kenna. I haven't watched, like, anybody play Kenna because I still want to play it. But if I had to take a guess already, likely 12 minutes. Because 12 minutes, everybody was talking about.
12 minutes or Kenna?
The game award for best independent game goes to... Kena, Bridge of Spirits.
Oh, Kenna.
There we go.
Kenna what? Okay. Okay, I'm not mad at that.
Kena, Bridge of Spirits also wins Best Debut Indie Game.
Oh. Yeah, they had a really pretty looking game. Good for them.
I mean, it looks so dismal.
Oh, it's heavy. Well, yeah, you know, it was an amazing journey to get here. Took a lot of hard work from an awesome team. A few of them are here today, but just can't say enough about the amazing people we worked with on, to make this game and to make the vision come true. Have to take our partners at Sony, who kind of believed in us from the very beginning, gave us a great opportunity, and all the guys at Epic who just have been there from the beginning. So thank you, everyone, and this is a great honor. Thank you.
Good for them. All right. So far, we're doing good.
Awesome. Congratulations, guys. All right. Now it's time to look into the future. 2 years ago, this team announced their game on this very stage. Now they're back with the first gameplay reveal. When I saw this, I could not believe it was actual gameplay. But it is, captured by the team in-game this past weekend. Sit back and get ready to experience a new level of cinematic immersion.
Breath of the Wild? Me? I don't know.
Breath of the Wild? Okay, buddy.
And she said,
Ninja Theory.
With our swords, we will forge new stories to strike the gods that haunt us.
Why does this look familiar?
I don't know.
might see me as weak.
But oh. I'll show you what lies wait a second. Oh boy. This game looking.
We will embrace our suffering.
He's a jammer.
Soothe our scars of grief and break their siege of our minds. You may see them as gods, but we will show you what lies behind their eyes.
Wait. There is something in the cave.
It's Shrek.
Shrek is in the cave. Oh, so this is actual gameplay when she's moving like that right there? Life
for what you believe is your sacrifice to make.
Still looks like it's the cinematics. To death.
I think that's gameplay. Kind of burden. Like, I think that's what they were saying. It's like cinematic gameplay. Like, it looks
intriguing.
That it actually looks that good.
Look at Shrek.
When was Shrek ever that big? Get out of my swamp. Yeah, this is definitely gameplay. Vin Diesel appears here.
Can you smell their fear?
You smell what the rock is cooking.
Look at the bones. Look at the bones. That's going to be you.
It's the baby. Oh my god. What the hell? What in the Attack on Titan am I looking at? What the hell, bro?
Those whose eyes are clouded by fear are besieged by the ghosts that haunt them.
Man, Attack on Titan gotta be heated about this.
Damn, he's fully naked.
Break it with an unshakable truth.
Ew.
With an impossible feat.
What the hell, bro? Damn. My guy had too many quarter pounders. He in pain.
He ate too much of the Whopper, man.
Too many Whoppers.
This is what it does to you.
He's just trying to sleep.
3, 2, 1.
What? Excuse me? This is like an Attack on Titan took place like thousands of years before Attack on Titan take place. Let him sleep.
It's gonna come out.
The baby went demon time. Freaking demons. Oh my god! This is what happens when you mess with the baby.
Oh she!
Oh, he angry. He angry. Look at him. Oh, hell no.
Run!
Throw that thing! Hey! That thing bounced off his head. Good job. Y'all didn't think this one through, did you? You'd be angry too if you were trying to sleep and got lit on fire.
Oh my
yeah! Give me the spear. I will throw it at his forehead. I threw it at his nose and it bounced off. Keep running. There's always that one person that dramatically trips. Come on, get up. Run. Damn, bro. She had to run through that fire. Keep running. He's gonna go through the fire.
It's me it wants to kill.
Oh, it wants her? Stop throwing those. It ain't working.
Go for the eye.
You got a full send it. Go. Get on the boat. Damn. We better start running. Oh my god. Oh yeah, he really attacked on Titan and them things. What the hell? When they gonna realize homeboy is immortal? Who knows? Yeah, that was Attack on Titan all over again. I mean, it looked good. It did look good.
Truly incredible. That's not a cinematic, that's gameplay, and that's why we do world premieres, because the state of our art just keeps getting better. Thanks to Ninja Theory for that incredible piece. And now, it's time for our first of many brand new game announcements at the Game Awards. I hope you're ready.
Brand new game? Okay.
Why is there so many out of space?
I don't know. Star Wars? Star Wars game?
Possibly.
Yeah, I said because of Lucasfilm, so it has to be Star Wars at this point.
Hey, it has to be.
Oh, look at the little thing. Ooh, that's you right there.
It is Star Wars.
Yeah, that dude was you. Got that. Octopus.
Is that you, Val?
Okay, right.
Squidward.
Oh my god, it's Yoder, bro. Look at Yoder. Oh my god, I love Yoder. Oh my god. I can't believe it. Oh my god, is that a lightsaber? Oh man. Oh shoot. Dang, these bald dudes sort of know how to play the drums. I could crank that up a little bit. Dang, they know what they doing. I like that. Dang, they should put me up there. I could do that. I will be their leader. That's what I like, boys. That's what's up. Oh, hell no. Y'all ugly as hell. I can't be with you.
Why do they look like the Avatar?
They missing a proper nose. Oh, they were summoning something.
Oh my god, it's the Dunes. It's the Dunes guy.
Oh, hell no. I know what you're talking about. Oh my god. What is that? Star Wars Eclipse? Damn, okay. Yeah, Voldemort, yeah. Voldemort. New Star Wars game, Star Wars Eclipse. I don't know. I mean, if it's fun, I'll play it. I played the other Star Wars game. Not actual gameplay, you don't say. You don't say.
What a way to kick off our game announcement. Star Wars Eclipse will be the first game set in the High Republic era of the Star Wars galaxy, and it is being created by Quantic Dream in collaboration with Lucasfilm Games and is currently in early development. All right, there are many more game announcements to come, trust me, as well as awards. All night, we are partnering with YouTube Shorts. If you have a favorite nominee tonight that doesn't win, let us know your thoughts by posting a YouTube Short with the hashtag GotShorted and head to the YouTube Gaming Twitter handle to find out how to get your very own salty consolation gift. All right now it's time to meet our first Global Gaming Citizen, a program we started back in 2018 to turn our air over to individuals who are building positive, inclusive communities around gaming.
Dino thought it was Dune 2, Rez. He saw that guy and he was like, Dune.
It's Dune.
I grew up playing games. Games was as a little kid, as a little gay boy, not knowing why I'm so different. Games gave me a place to feel safe and to be myself.
Foi uma espécie de escape. quando eu encontrei os jogos, quando eu comecei a jogar, eu acabei criando ali o meu espaço, sabe? Criando ali a minha, o meu mundo.
It gave me a reference to be inspired, to build up all this drag, this insane costume, all this makeup, all this hair, but feel powerful. Because as a kid,
well, is
weak,
that you
like
gonna
be?
Excuse me.
Foi daí que eu conheci
o
serviço de
streaming,
e eu senti muito essa necessidade.
Excuse me? What did you just say?
What did you just say?
No, I hate to break it to you, but I'm not gonna have the hair flowing like that. I know it looks great, okay, but I'm just
interests. You can be.
I'm not doing that. I hate to break it.
So close.
You don't. I probably look great with the wig.
Things that make you different. They can be what make you special.
It's Facebook Gaming. Oh my god.
Facebook Gaming, is that what that was?
Yes, it was.
I see. Keith cosplay. I don't get paid enough to do that. I'm sorry. I hate to break it to you. You said him but bald? Okay. Okay, chat. Okay. That's fine. What is this? Damn commercial? You said someone pinged me on Discord when they either give Metroid Dread an award or Metroid Prime 4 gets revealed? I got you, don't worry. Listen, if you're gonna show me this damn inside of this PC or some crap, you better give me a PC for free. Let me get that sponsorship. Give you a new DMC? How about AMD? How about you get an AMD chip for your PC? Bethesda? We don't like those guys.
Hi, Pete Hines here. Yeah, we've got some stuff on sale, but let's all take a breather while we give away hundreds of free game codes.
That's what that is?
A small way of saying thank you for playing our games for the past 35 years.
You don't even know what game you're gonna get.
And we're just getting started. From Ghostwire to Redfall to Starfield, and much more, including stuff that hasn't even leaked yet. So if you can't imagine doing anything other than developing and publishing games with us,
you know it's great? The fact that I dislike Bethesda so much that I could care less that they're putting all of those codes.
So consider this your invitation to join us.
I'm just like,
a lot of work to be done, and we're running out of platforms to port Skyrim.
They're giving away so many games. Wow, guys, if you want to screenshot and get a Bethesda game, there's your opportunity.
Here's a bunch of legal text.
Wow. It's not like Bethesda's done a bunch of scummy stuff before. So. What's this?
This is the foolish dream of mortals.
Oh boy.
This
am I gonna see Aquaman, bro?
Is more dangerous than you.
Aquaman!
Let's
just be some damn World of Warcraft. I got no idea what this is. Damn, okay, Bayonetta.
Once again, the chaos gates have burst open. The demon legions of Kazaros blot out the sun.
Is there? Can we end this? Can we? Could we? Please. You know, I'd like to get back to seeing what game wins an award. Thanks. Appreciate it. Okay. Okay. What do we got?
That was a new look at Lost Ark from Amazon Games coming in February. And speaking of Amazon, we're proud to partner with Prime Gaming on the Game Awards. This month, you can level up your gaming experience with free games, including Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit, Tales of Monkey Island, and Frostpunk. There's always something new to play.
Do I look like I
want to
play Tales of Monkey Island?
The games you already own, you can unlock skins, weapons, and more, including in League of Legends, New World, Apex Legends, and Roblox. Check regularly for new drops and surprises at gaming.amazon.com. Next. In the days leading into the Game Awards, I read the internet with a little bit of fear, wondering if some of tonight's big surprises might leak. This one sure didn't. It's time for a new game announcement that no one had on their bingo card. Enjoy.
Jeff, if you're going to say this, you better give me something good. You better give me something good, Jeff. If nobody...
Interesting.
A new threat comes to our shores, and I must call you home.
It's a Dr. Fate game, bro.
Restore what has been brought.
Justice League game?
Unite old enemies. Forge.
It's a... Oh, Injustice 3!
You are a hero. But you can be more.
Wonder Woman game?
You can be a leader.
A Wonder Woman game?
Our Wonder Woman.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna play that. Okay, that gotta be good. Okay, yeah, nobody knew there was gonna be a Wonder Woman game. Okay, that's pretty sick.
The actors who portrayed Ellie and Abby in The Last of Us Part 2.
Everybody's favorite game.
Please welcome Ashley Johnson and Laura Bailey.
But no, okay, Wonder Woman, I'll take it.
Every year, the Best Performance category brings surprising new faces and portrayals of wildly different characters. Tonight's nominated actors continue this tradition, once again stunning us with their extraordinary depth and dedication.
Here are the nominees for Best Performance.
Ooh. Who gets Best Performance? They're gonna give it to Resident Evil lady Dimitrescu.
The worst parts of you.
Dimitrescu. For him. The cost give it to Dimitrescu.
Eight geniuses give it to her. Painted up a prison and named it Freedom.
You escaped my little brother.
Yeah, baby. If she doesn't win this thing, this whole show is rigged. If she does not win, I say it again, this show is rigged. There is no way in any dimension, in any multiverse, that this lady doesn't win. I'm gonna say that right now.
And the Game Award.
She has to win.
Best performance goes to.
She has to win.
Hopefully.
Maggie Roberts.
Yeah! I knew it.
What are you staring at, bro?
I'm not staring at anything.
Yeah, you are.
I'm a man of the Lord. I'm the man of the Lord. Shit.
Wow, that was the scariest walk I've ever done in my life. Thank you so much. It is an honor to receive this award, and it is an honor to be standing here in front of you all today. I would like to give a really huge thank you
to
Capcom
for looking at it.
Creating an amazing game full of wonderfully rich and dynamic characters, of which Lady D is but one. And to Rosanna and DJ with The Workhouse, to Steve Knibley, our amazing cinematics director. I've said this before, but I'm going to say it again because I'm a broken record. You took a chance on me when you hired me for this role, and in doing so, you have changed my life. Being a part of this game, playing this role, and becoming a member of this amazing community has changed my life. So thank you so, so much.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. All hope has been restored in this world. I told you she had to win. Listen, chat. She did a great job with her voice. She honestly did, in like all seriousness. She killed that role.
What am I looking at?
Alan Wake 3. That hope
without ever finding the story. This is not the story you want it to be. This story will eat you alive.
John Wick. That you? Oh, no. Like.
Is a monster.
Silent Hill? Monsters wear many faces. Alan Wake 2. I didn't know that there was only one Alan Wake game. How did I know? I said Alan Wake 3, but I just somehow knew it was going to be Alan Wake. Wow, you see that, chat?
Gotcha. All right, I'm now joined by my man, I'm pretty Sam good at this. Lake. Sam, thank you for coming all the way over from Finland for this. This is so exciting. Alan Wake 2, it's been a decade. Fans have been asking you for it. Why is now the right time to bring him back?
Well, Jeff, first of all, I want to say apologies. It's been raining here in Los Angeles today. It's on us. Fiction leaking out into reality. So sorry. Anyway, yeah, 10 years, over 10 years. Wanting to make this, dreaming of making it, we've been iterating on the concept, and we know fans have been asking for it.
I never played it, but I know people protective. Like it a lot.
We knew this is going to be a pretty scary experience. Now we are convinced everybody is ready. You are ready.
What kind of game are we going to get for the sequel? Can you tell us something about it?
Yeah, we are breaking new ground here. This is going to be Remedy's first ever survival horror game.
Ooh,
take on the genre. Yeah. The first game had horror elements to it, but it was an action game.
Yeah.
And we feel that this is the perfect genre to bring together the story and gameplay closer than ever before. Because the story, horror story, is at the very heart of this, and it's psychological, layered, deep mystery to dive into.
That's actually pretty cool.
You are such an incredible visionary. I can't wait to see what you're doing with this game. I know you said to me a while ago this was your dream project, and I'm so honored that we got to announce this here at the Game Awards. So we're going to hear more next year, I think, right?
Yes. Fitting to the theme,
yes.
We're going to go dark for a while to work on this.
Yeah.
We'll be back next year, summertime, to show more.
All right, summer 2022, more on Alan Wake 2. Sam, thank you so much for that announcement.
Thank you.
Very exciting. All right. Well, now
I like how Jeff gave the time of when they were going to talk more about the game, but not the dude that was making it. He's like, sometime next year. Okay. Wait, what are we hearing? Oh, hell no. That's a copyright claim. That's the Sonic voice actor. Okay, I thought he was with it before. Oh, that's the Sonic movie guy. Oh boy.
Everybody, my name is Sonic Schwartz. I played the voice of Sonic the Hedgehog in the Sonic the Hedgehog movies. Thank you. That's very kind. Thank you very much. And I just wanted to say thank you so much for supporting our movie. Also, thank you very much for the note about Sonic's legs and teeth in our original trailer. That's a good note. That's a good note. I'm really happy that worked out. We needed that. We really needed that. The good news is, so many of you loved our first movie that we got to make a sequel. And today, yes! Video game movies, come on! Yes! Sure, two other people at the end. Today, I brought with me the trailer to that sequel.
I hate when people hold CDs like that.
This isn't like the real trailer. This is a blank DVD for effect. If this was the real trailer, I feel like we'd be screwed because there's no computer with a DVD drive anymore, so this would be, like, troublesome. Anyway, I can't tell you how excited we all are about Sonic 2. So many incredible people are in this movie. We got James Marsden, Tika Sumpter, Colleen O'Shaughnessy as Tails, Idris Elba as Knuckles.
We'll see how that goes.
And, of course, the legend Jim Carrey as Dr. Robotnik. Now, Jim has actually sent a very special video over to say hello to all of you, and you guys are in luck, because I have the video with me right here. Callback! I'm happy. Just kidding. This is blank still. Let's roll the video, Jim. What do you say?
Hello, everyone, and hello, Ben. I'm sorry I couldn't be there with you, but I look forward to meeting all of your avatars in the metaverse, where we can really get
in the metaverse.
Hey, before you see this exciting new Sonic trailer, I'd like to pass on a word of advice that my Scottish grandfather gave to me when I was just a boy. He said, son, don't grate it in the grinder. Don't do it, son. Don't grate it in the grinder, boy. Grate it. By all means, grate it till the cows come home. But don't grate it in the grinder. And then to drive the point home, he put his hands around my neck and he squeezed real hard and he said, don't do it, son! Don't grate it in the grinder!
Are you listening to me, boy?
Oh my God.
Are you listening?
Jesus. That sounds like a great family moment. Yes, yeah. That was great.
Inspiring words.
Yeah. Put it in the grinder.
Thank you, Jim. You know, I think we all needed to hear that. Yeah, take it in if you need to. Good? Great. Okay, here we go. Thank you again for continuing to support the Blue Blur, and it is my honor to present to you the trailer for Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Yeah. Enjoy.
Let's see. We just found out about a story of him getting strangled, but you know.
Oh boy.
Quick stretch, little snack, and here we go.
Sonic, I love that you want to help make a difference.
Mind if I drive?
But you're being reckless.
Don't worry, nobody's gonna get hurt.
Pretending to be Batman.
Blue Justice, trademark pending.
You're still just a kid.
Woohoo!
Trust me, there will come a moment when your powers will be needed. But you don't choose that moment. That moment chooses you.
I just got goosebumps. Wait a second, did you steal that from Oprah?
What?
Oh my God.
Papa's got a brand new stash.
Oh my God.
Since I've been gone, I've discovered the source of ultimate power.
Oh. Oh my God. That
sounds big.
It's an infinity stone. Oh my God, guys.
Hope I'm not too late.
I'm sorry, who are you?
It's Tales.
Okay, this is what we're gonna do. Step one, light taunting. Step two, I have no idea.
Hang on!
That wasn't too bad.
Oh my God.
Today's forecast calls for a 100% chance of adventure. Return to sender. Face it, you're never going to get my power.
Oh. Oh, is that Knuckles?
Do I look like I need your power?
Oh. Dang, Knuckles said, come here.
Where are my manners? Sonic, meet Knuckles.
Then we about to get bodied. Okay.
So fun. All right. Next, one of your nominees tonight for most anticipated game is Horizon Forbidden West from Guerrilla Games. The team is
now, where's the Mario movie?
In Amsterdam, finishing it up for a February release, but I'm grateful they put together this for the fans.
What they got for us? Horizon? Okay. This game. What we've seen just looks so ridiculous.
And the machines are out of control.
Yeah, this game just visually, like, it's really gonna show off what that PS5 could do. Because Lord, especially look underwater. You're gonna have underwater combat, just beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I enjoyed the first game very much. Is that Aloy from the hit game Genshin Impact? Yeah, it is, yeah. You see, they made a game about her. And, you know, she got her own game. Pretty crazy. Dang, she got the red outfit on, okay.
Aquawoman.
Red turtle gets bodied.
The snake.
You said, this game looks amazing, not getting a PS5 till next year, though. Yeah, hopefully a lot more people are able to get a PS5. Ooh. Yeah, hit me with that music. This is my favorite type of music, non-copyrighted. I feel like I'm being chased already. I just died right there in my, yeah.
This is so cool.
It's very good. Like, this will be an automatic nominee for Game of the Year next year. It will be up there.
Good job, good job.
Yeah, their music's great. But, we'll definitely, next year's Game of the Year, it's going to be some tough competition. I already know. It's going to be real tough. What's up? Welcome to the stream, lad. How you doing? How you doing? Just like, damn, that was good.
Wow, Game Awards Orchestra, thank you so much. I am so ready for this game. Thank you so much to Lauren and the orchestra, and in her first ever performance and trip to the United States, the beautiful Julie Elvin. Thank you so much, Julie.
Clap it up, clap it up.
Well, speaking of music, last week you probably saw everyone posting their Spotify Wrapped on social media. My top artists of 2021, Rufus Du Sol, Sam Fender, and Dayglow. You can make your Spotify Wrapped now in the app and stick around as we reveal for the first time
the most listened to Spotify artists
and songs on gaming consoles in 2021. Also on the music front, some of the music we've been playing tonight is from Sessions Diana. Sessions is Riot Games' project with music made to be safe to stream without fears of copyright issues. Check out Sessions.
That sounds like my type of music.
Download the full album. And now it's time for a special and long-awaited announcement.
Cloud.
Huh? Oh, that's hype. You're going to get Final Fantasy VII on PC? Is that what it is? The remake and the DLC? On the Epic Game Store? That's what you're doing? If so, that's pretty cool.
This will be a memory to cherish for the rest of your lives.
Yeah, incredible game. Absolutely incredible game. And DLC, top notch. Just what's coming to
it. Yeah.
Very beautiful.
Not your sister.
Cannot wait for the next part to it.
Let the hunt begin.
Mm-hmm. Hey! Best boy.
Mm-hmm.
This is just wrong.
Damn. I just got goosebumps from that scene. Why they gotta show that scene? Why they gotta do that? I'm not gonna talk about it, but oh, December 16th? Oh, wow.
Hundreds of games to choose
what
from.
Is this?
I don't even wanna. Oh, God.
Oh, just continue it.
What's your name? Game Pass. Xbox Game Pass for PC.
2021 Game Awards. Xbox Game Pass for PC. And you two. What do we think?
Isn't it so
effortful? I like that we animated.
You're welcome.
Okay, I understand the impulse to do something big, but what do PC gamers actually want? Because I don't think it's that.
They love brand new PC games.
We have some great ones coming day one.
Okay.
Some of them haven't even been announced yet.
Okay, great. Marketing idea. What if Gata tweets out this list, more or less leaking it in a cool, hip way? I retweet it because I have so many more followers than him.
It's done.
What's done?
Tweet it. It's out there.
No, you didn't. I don't think you should have
done
that.
I had to Twitter to see the new day one games.
When people think about Xbox Game Pass, they think about console. They don't know we're a PC gaming service.
Why not just call it PC Game Pass?
That's a great idea.
Really good.
Okay, we're going with that.
Just like that, you're going to change the name of the whole thing because of Gata, who calls himself Gata.
It's a good name.
All we got to do is add some top-tier streamers to this to really land it.
Gata, yes. What about 100 Thieves?
Big fans.
Was that so?
Oh, my God.
Where are the other 97?
I get it. That's fine.
Thank you, man. We'll take it from here, brothers.
They didn't ask me to be in this commercial, though. Right? It's fine. Yeah. Just talking about, like, they didn't invite me to the Game Awards. They didn't. They didn't mail me my badge in time. They didn't.
The Game Awards.
They didn't let me be in
a
commercial.
Rap in it at all. I mean, if I could get away with that.
Game Pass has PC games.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we are at the TGAs.
I guess that's kind of like saying we're at the Game Awards.
Those are Game Pass freaking codes. PC Game Pass codes, boys. Go put them in quick. You better screenshot of that or you screw.
What in the world? Yes.
It's Marvel, whatever the hell you'd even call this, marbles. This is what I wanted. And
what is this?
Oh my god, it's candy.
Is this mobile?
Yeah, we know you're a mobile gamer out there. We've got something just for you. Genshin Impact. Probably one of the worst ideas to play on mobile, because that game dies on mobile. Let's give you the Nintendo Switch, a console that has really good games, but needs an upgrade severely. But we refuse to give you an upgraded version. Instead, we're going to give you a version of the Switch with an OLED screen. You don't get an upgrade. Let your console suffer.
Mario Party.
Yeah. So, was that good, chat? Did I say all that right?
Hello Game Words, my name is Martin Foss Anderson, aka Mr. Savage. It's really bad if you're stressed before you're trying to play a game and trying to win it. If I was stressed after school, I just wouldn't be able to focus properly, and it would just make everything 10 times harder. Together with Truth, I have an important message. Vaping nicotine can increase anxiety symptoms and stress levels. I think it's really important people know the truth about vaping nicotine.
Don't be vaping out here. Don't be doing crack. Don't be doing cocaine. Don't be doing heroin. Listen. I better not find out y'all been smoking that crack out here. If I find out, I'm gonna be very disappointed, chat. You're not allowed to do that. Love some good old commercials, but the show has to get funded somehow, right? Like, I understand why we have to go through these sequences that put us to sleep. They have to make money somehow to be able to make the show go on. Where do you get money?
Yeah.
Sponsors. I get it.
Now, please welcome actor Simu Liu.
Oh, it's Shang-Chi.
Hey!
I saw you weren't wearing your mask earlier, Shang-Chi. What's going on with it? Everybody in the crowd was.
Oh, hey guys, what's up?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I'm here to present the Game Award for Best Action, I guess. And, oh, shoot, that's so sick! Sorry. So, you know, as a martial arts superhero myself, I know a little thing or two about action and, oh, snap, with the plasma sword? sorry. Where was I? The prompter, right? Action is the best when it's kinetic and fast-paced and totally organic No, you did not, Master Chief. No, you didn't. Sorry, guy. Look, you guys know that Halo just came out, right? And it's literally sitting in my living room while I gotta be here. So instead of actually playing Halo, I'm on stage presenting the Game Award for Best Action while watching streamers on Twitch. Seemed like a pretty reasonable compromise. Anyway, here are the nominees.
Okay. I'm sorry, chat. I'm not somebody who's gonna fake laugh. If I'm not laughing, I'm sorry. Listen, I'm not somebody who laughs at like everything. Who are the nominees? I saw Deathloop. What else is in here? Arkrai? Okay, Returnal? I'll just say Returnal, because I heard Returnal is really good. I'll go for that.
Sorry. And the Game Award for Best Action Game goes to... Returnal.
Damn, I'm pretty on point right now, you know what I'm saying, you know.
Good job, though.
Not too bad, I told you, chat. You see, I've seen the answers. I already know what the Game of the Year is this year. I already know. But we're not going to get into that.
Or perhaps you kind of cheated.
No, I wouldn't cheat. No. He's got that speech ready. He's about to read that thing. Go crazy.
Wow. Thank you. We are so happy to be here to accept the award for everyone who worked on Returnal. When I first joined Housemarque, I could tell Returnal was a really special game, and it was our amazing team that pulled it off and brought you the game that you played today. Thank you to the amazing team at Housemarque in Helsinki, Finland, our incredible co-dev partners who helped us build Returnal, our amazing partners at XDev, represented by Pedro, and everyone at PlayStation. We're so grateful we could build a game like Returnal. But biggest thanks, obviously, has to go to the players. Thank you for playing, and thank you for supporting Returnal.
Wonderful. Respect to them in the game.
He's like, here, take the award, my guy.
Get your palm back here.
They get taken into like a black hole back there so they can go back home. It's factual information. Chat, why y'all on his hairline? Listen, I saw the hairline, but I wasn't gonna say anything. I was gonna leave the man be.
Is that? It can't be.
It is.
Just start at the beginning.
We landed on Mars.
Ah, Destiny 2. You know, Destiny 2 is a game that I would like to get back into. It's just you need like 6 people in total to be able to do raids. And to find 6 people that will consistently play one game like Destiny,
that's not easy.
I mean, I'm willing to do it, but...
I mean, I'm willing to do it too. That's 2 of us, but we'd need more. Man, Destiny 1 back in the day, I used to play so much. It was so good. And now Destiny's actually gotten good again, since it's back to just Bungie doing their thing, I'm pretty sure, without Activision. Yeah. Once Activision was out of the picture, next? Things got better for them.
Brought me back. We kept going. She knew we would.
And that's when you saw the knight.
Yeah, I mean, like, legitimately, I could vouch for this game. I can. Just because of how much I played of the series. There's a coke load. Them raids, when everybody was doing their part in the raid and then one person doesn't do what they're supposed to do, oh my god, we screaming at them at the top of our lungs. You'd be terrified to make a mistake.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. But he said, this looks like Life is Strange. Yeah. Life is Strange be doing this? they be doing this in Life is Strange?
I forgot though. Are you a warrior?
I'm a hunter. The class I chose was hunter.
Yeah.
I had a warlock, but hunter was my jam. We
needed to know what. Yeah, same here.
Mm-hmm.
We couldn't stop. One shot, one kill.
Mm-hmm. Damn,
I really do miss playing this game. Damn, chat. I gotta find people that go play this.
What has she done?
But you gotta buy the DLC as well.
Yeah, we gotta get all the damn DLC, Jesus.
My Destiny 2 is just there with the DLCs bought.
Damn.
Looks so, so good. Destiny 2 The Witch Queen, that is coming out in February. And everything you saw there is actually from the first mission of the game, which is so cool. And Bungie is celebrating their 30th anniversary this year. So congratulations to Bungie. And there's a lot of great stuff happening in Destiny 2 right now to celebrate 30 years of Bungie. All right, now it is time to get to another new game announcement. A few months ago, a Japanese game creator reached out to me and said, hey, I want to announce my next game at the Game Awards, and I'm so honored to have this opportunity to present this global announcement to all of you. Please enjoy.
Kojima, you make a game? This Kojima game?
Oh, it's Silent Hill.
Wow. Boy.
He's going to make a new horror game. Interesting. Please be a good one.
Oh no. You want more than your body.
What is this Parasite?
Oh my god.
Holy crap, it is Parasite.
Oh my god, okay, well that's oh. This is very different.
So I
thought it was going to be.
This seems like a horror action, to be honest.
Okay. Slither.
I thought it was going to be on full-on horror.
What? Okay.
That's a fun one. It's clear Tori Amazon has not abandoned his roots. Thank you again for that very special announcement. Speaking of just that, we have another brand new game to announce from a studio comprised of many industry veterans. Check this out.
Yeah, I need something to cleanse my eyes.
You want something wholesome, don't you?
I don't think this is wholesome. This looks like the opposite of wholesome.
Is this Alice in Wonderland or something?
What the hell? Oh, hell no. What is that?
What is...
Listen, you should have had some better convenient clothes on than that.
Today, the portal network collapsed, stranding us in these realms. We have searched for a way home.
Lost and alone in the dangerous labyrinth of fantastical worlds.
Mm.
Welcome to the lands of Fae.
Damn.
Every portal is a chance for salvation. Uniting the lost survivors.
Why does everyone have more than one mouth here? That's a great question.
Or leading us deep.
Damn, it's the green giant's cousin, bro. Holy crap.
The hell? The tree is alive?
There's a lot going on here.
Well, damn, all we got that hard work for
Nightingale.
Basically Minecraft.
Our beacon of hope. But beyond our reach. As long as we stand together, our journey will unite us.
Look, they built the Nether portal.
Oh my god.
You, the realm walkers, are all that is left.
Oh my, oh Jesus, yeah, Minecraft is here. Yeah, it's only been an hour so far, huh? Oh, okay. I'm still thinking about that Wonder Woman game, huh? That's gonna be hella fun.
Love brand new IP, and joining me now is Aaron Flynn from Inflection Games. Aaron, you were on stage at the first Game Awards in 2014, accepting Game of the Year for Dragon Age, and now you've got a new studio, Inflection, up in Canada. What kind of game do we get here with Nightingale?
Oh, well, thanks, Jeff. Yeah, so it's a survival crafting game, shared world idea, so we want to bring players together, solo experiences, cooperative experiences, lots of ability to go and explore these amazing, fantastical, magical realms we're going to give players, lots of ability to come together, cooperate, lots of opportunity for community building, that sort of thing.
Wow, it looks incredible. Adult Minecraft. I love it. Show me this game a while ago. I was like, this looks so cool. We have to show this to people. And you're pretty far along. That's real gameplay footage, so people will play it next year?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. So we're going to be in early access next year on PC only. And looking forward to inviting players in. If you want to see more, play Nightingale.com.
PC Master Race.
Well, thank you for that announcement.
What's up, Shoto?
Nice
how you doing?
For the Game Awards. And tonight, we've got much more coming up, but we're also going to introduce you to our Game Awards second annual Future Class, a group of 50 individuals who represent the bright, bold, and inclusive future of our industry. You can see the full list at thegameawards.com tonight. We're also partnering with Google Play to have our future class mentor the next generation of women in gaming.
You said anything that you missed?
Google Play's changed the game.
They're making a Wonder Woman game.
Female representation in gaming.
Persona 4 Ultimax, the fighting game, is going to be on consoles next year in March.
From last year's future class.
Rez, what else am I missing?
Right now, meet one of the new members of our future class.
Horizon.
Horizon, they showed. There's going to be an Alan Wake 2.
Oh, I'm DJ Knight. And ice cream ones.
And a lot of indie and.
You gotta hate me right now, and I love it. My focus is.
Oh my god, you gonna self promote in my damn stream? Damn, self promote, damn.
Oh yeah, I forgot the Sonic trailer.
Oh yeah, they did show the Sonic trailer and stuff, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wow, look.
You know, I see they have quite a liking to Amazon and Twitch. They get that good Amazon check. They're like, hey, everybody, Amazon, Twitch, we're still cool over here, okay, guys? You know what I'm saying? So, please.
So, Vel, when are you going to be in there?
Then what?
You know, it's a self-promo.
Hey guys, you already know, be sure to subscribe to the channel, you know, be sure to hit the like button if you haven't already, you know, if you'd like to become a member, you know, exclamation point member in chat, you know what I'm saying, if you'd like to donate, exclamation point donate, all that good stuff, you know, yeah, Wonder Woman game, yes, we are going to be getting a Wonder Woman video game. Right now, we see Beat Saber's being played, but, it's probably copyrighted music, so I don't want to show that right now, See, we're gonna just wait for that commercial to be over, you know? It seemed like they had see Lady Gaga, so if I would have been playing that, I would have get hit with a copyright claim. So I did not want that. What is this? Don't
let him see what us. Game is this?
They'll find us. Oh my god, it's the Schmeagle game. Yes. It is the Schmeagle
game. Lord of the Ring?
Oh my god, bruh. It's Schmeagle.
Oh, it is Lord of the Rings! Hey,
oh,
let's
shoot!
Go.
About to be relaxing 20 years, bro. You about to be.
Damn, man, look at how relaxed! He's been chopping the face!
Relax, I hit down tremendously!
Oh, shoot! He hasn't said ground!
Damn, bro, he got a whole cave to himself. He out here killing people!
Damn,
I'm coming to PS5.
Hi, Game Awards. It's Ms. Tech. Final Fantasy XIV just released its latest expansion,
Endwalker.
And to celebrate, they're partnering with Grubhub on something really cool. Check out this piece
Grubhub,
with them
you say.
Enjoy the rest of your show. All right, everyone, let's focus up. It's time to raid. All right, this is
it's time to raid, guys. Let me. I'm not gonna start typing on my keyboard. I'm gonna start raiding. So.
Seriously, where did you get the pizza?
Now when you order with Grubhub using code Endwalker, you get free delivery and unlock an exclusive pizza emote in Final Fantasy XIV.
Oh my god!
That's so beautiful. I'm crying on my pepperoni.
I'm too broke for Grubhub. I'm sorry. I don't have enough money. Hey. Feels bad, chat. Feels bad.
It's battleground, dude.
Oh my god. People still play PUBG? Chat, does any... You know, I'm not trying to offend anybody, chat, but does anybody in here actually play PUBG? Like, I'm genuinely curious. Does anybody play this? In 2021?
Why play PUBG if you play PUBG?
I don't know if that's copyrighted music, so we're gonna mute it again. Alright, yeah, get some free pizza. Any awards been given out? Yeah, you know, Resident Evil Village, you know, Lady Dimitrescu. You know, big tall lady, yeah, she won for best performance, so yeah, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. And then Returnal won best was it action game or something? Yeah, Returnal won, so pretty cool. PUBG. Oh my god, will this lady stop showing up? Oh my god, she's just promoting a Twitch channel again. Oh my gosh, bro. It's like asking someone if they live on Mars, yeah, about PUBG. Oh my god, lady, please stop showing up on my screen.
Do it now.
Back in the summer of 2019, I visited this first-time developer at his studio in the United Kingdom. He told me his dream was to one day share his game with the world at the Game Awards. Well, that dream is about to come true. Enjoy.
She hacked the system or something? She showed up in the pre-show like 3 times trying to self-promote.
Actually, it's 4 times.
Oh, you... Well, now it's 4 times, right?
Wow, this looks so peaceful but menacing.
Zombies.
Zombies.
Oh my god, I could play as Tony Stark. That's a ship, that's not Tony Stark. Damn. Mm-hmm. Is that Joel from The Last of Us? Oh, wait. Where is she coming from? Oh, no, bro. Okay.
Somerville.
I'm about to see her in my nightmares if they keep showing her. Bet you they're gonna show her like a good 2 to 3 more times before this thing's over.
I cannot wait to play Somerville, thanks to Chris Olsen and the team at Jump Ship for that one. Next, we're gonna head to the stage for a very special performance from a much-loved game studio.
What is this?
Asbestos.
It's video game music, so I'm not stressing. Cuphead? Oh, shoot! They're finally gonna give us news on Cuphead, dude. I'm gonna get that DLC. Oh, shoot. I'm acting like I've beaten Cuphead. Respectfully, the one in the middle, man, she sort of bad. Respectfully.
It's a delicious last course. Well, the delicious last course. One can eat their fill and still stay until the delicious last course. It's a delicious last course. Oh, that delicious last course. There starts cakes and pies, a dozen scones. Oh, my, for that delicious last course.
Oh, Miss Chalice just wants to be just as real as real can be. With the one more tart, she could then take heart. It's off to the bakery.
Chef's hot maker has a plan. The best tart maker in the land. If they're expedient with the ingredients, then he might just lend a hand.
With that delicious last course. Oh, the delicious last course. If there's a single meal to help make Chalice real, it's a delicious last course. Oh, the delicious last course. Oh, the delicious last course. Searching all the cart to get the one at a time. For the delicious last course. Using recipes to get necessities. For the delicious last course. With a wink and a song, as long as nothing goes wrong.
Listen, chat, somebody find me the girl in the middle of Twitter or something. I need it for research. Somebody out there find her. Yeah, you missed quite a bit if you haven't been watching it. Oh, here we go.
Drop it.
It is Cuphead time. DLC Island. Wow, people have been waiting years for this.
What in the world is this?
Bugman and the lovely Miss Chalice. They're off on their next adventure. This time to the fabled DLC Island. What challenges await in this enchanted land? What better way to explore the island than with a leisurely climb into the mountains? Just remember to watch your step.
Oh my god.
Ooh. So I'm guessing this is 3 players now?
Yeah, 3 player gameplay? Or is it still 2 player and they just have another character now?
The dramatic Western Plains under the watchful eye of Sheriff Winchester. Yeehaw! But what's this? Why, it's Chef with his famous cookies. He's the best baker in the land.
What the hell?
Are sure to put some pep in your step. Oh! And you'll need it. For there's a new challenge waiting around every corner on the amazing...
Oh man, I haven't played Cuphead in years. June 30th, 2022. Well, there you go. You finally get the date. I gotta go back and do like a full Cuphead series of actually beating the game.
Yeah, you only played it with your dad.
Mm-hmm. We have a date, June 30th, 2022. So exciting. The delicious last course. All right. Next up, earlier you saw the trailer for Sonic 2, the movie. And now it's time for the little blue guy to give you a glimpse at his next game, also coming in 2022.
We're gonna see the game?
Oh, little blue guy.
Oh shoot, they're showing us the Sonic game, the new Sonic?
Oh, I thought they meant Smurf.
The Smurfs? What are you talking about?
He's the little blue guy.
I bet you relax. He's like,
where is Relax?
He said he's watching it with his friend.
Oh my.
Ah.
Open world Sonic game. We swear it won't be Sonic 06. We promise it won't be Sonic 06. Please believe us. We're gonna show you the world. We'll show you where Sonic runs. We'll show you where Sonic sleeps. Why this give me Sonic and a Black Knight vibes? Frontiers. Holiday.
2022.
Oh, damn. This looks like a more serious Sonic game, though. I'm gonna be honest. It doesn't look like a little baby Sonic game. Which I like. Good, good. This could potentially be what I actually want.
小島秀夫です。今年もですね、TG に参加できなくてごめんなさい。来年は必ず出席させていただきます。僕の戦友であります、ギレルモ・デルトロ監督の最新作、ナイトメアアレイをご紹介します。どうぞ。
All right, let's see.
I got a little job for you. It's just temporary. The folks here, they don't make no never mind who you are or what you done.
William Dafoe, bro.
Everything's gotta be new these days. Sensational.
Oh, hell.
Oh, my.
Let the mirrors show you who you are.
What's your pitch, pal? You on the level?
I'd love to learn anything that you want to teach me.
I don't mess with the circus.
I can read them more quick, find out what they want.
Folks will pay good money just to make themselves feel better. When a man believes his own lies.
Yeah, so this is a TV show. But, or a movie.
Then you lie. You try to find your way out.
Oh, that's Sonic chat. That freaking Sonic.
There is
I was
no
happy
way
with
out.
What I saw so far. There's a movie. I was very happy with what I saw.
Wow, that was the best trailer I've seen since Death Stranding. Now, onto awards business. I am honored to be announcing the best art direction category. These nominees across a broad variety of budgets and genres each found their own path to combining visual design, music, and animation into their own distinct expression of intent and purpose. You know, one franchise I love the art direction in, Silent Hill. I hope we get a new one of those. Anyhow, here are the nominees for Best Art Direction.
All right, you say that. I hope you get a new one. Enough.
Best Art Direction.
I hope there is a new.
What did you say? Art Direction? Look, tuned up.
Canna.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, the Game Awards so far, it's been good other than the ads, but I know the ads have to be in there, but art design? Ooh.
I mean, I like Ratchet and Clank.
Ratchet and Clank was ridiculously beautiful. And that ray tracing and just everything is just... Oh my god, it was beautiful. I don't know.
And the Game Award for Best Art Direction goes to...
Kenna or Ratchet?
Kenna.
Deathloop.
What?
That's the music that would play in my head after finding that Deathloop won that. What? Kenna or Ratchet and Clank didn't win for art design? Excuse me? Were we voting on the same thing, people? What happened? I'd like to know what happened here. That's very confusing.
This is super weird, because last night I made the bet that Guillermo del Toro will be giving this award, so... this is awkward. I will stick to my speech. So thank you, Guillermo, wherever you are. Thanks to the Game Awards. I now have a flashback of when I was studying the 60s era by watching his movie,
Very
The Shape of Water.
For art design? Compared to Ratchet and Clank? Did y'all see Ratchet and Clank? Did we see the same game?
Also,
did
thank you for your talking or patience like, for
there's
visual,
a huge difference in art direction.
Insane difference.
No attention to details. That's a
like, I could even say that without bias. Like, look at the difference between the two games.
Tonight, I'm proud, ladies and gentlemen, and I think like, guys across the ocean at Arcane are really proud too.
There are two so
for this fucking cool adventure.
What happened there?
Thanks to my long time buddies, Damien.
Maybe the dude read the wrong name, I don't know. Something happened there. Maybe he played Deathloop, he liked it too much.
We did it.
Or they just rigged.
Thanks to the great people at Bethesda, rigged. Sony,
yeah,
Microsoft.
That doesn't seem right to me.
A big hug for our families and friends. And lastly, I'd like to dedicate this award to the boss, Robert
Altman. They bribed them.
No, they bribed them.
No, they have. And French fries. Yes,
bribed.
I lost a bet last night also.
Congratulations to all the winners so far, and right now we are excited to announce additional winners tonight. In the 100% fan-voted Player's Voice category, here are the final five nominees, as voted on by fans. And the Game Award goes to Halo Infinite. Congratulations.
Makes sense. People hype as hell for it.
For Best RPG.
Oh, player.
Best RPG? Monster Hunter, probably.
And the Game Award goes to Tales of Arise.
Yes.
Okay.
For Best Score and Music, those nominees are... And the Game Award goes to...
Nier?
Nier Replicant. Next up is Content Creator of the Year. But first, let's hear from fans and creators themselves
on
who
God,
they
guys.
Want to win.
I'm about to get my award from home. Oh, man.
Creator of the Year.
I want Dream to win. Good luck, Dream.
It's all about the
No!
You say Dream?
Yeah, vote for Ebi.
No. Did you just say Dream?
I would like to nominate
Yeah, Dream is part of it,
Creator of the Year.
Listen, chat, did you vote for me on the non-existent website?
Well, let's see
who
is right. Here are the nominees for Content Creator
of
the Year.
Dream. Please. Don't be Dream.
And the Game Award goes to...
Don't be Dream.
Congratulations, Dream. Of course, not here in person. Here are the nominees for Best Multiplayer Game. And the Game Award goes to... It Takes Two.
I think anybody could have guessed that.
Joseph, you did it.
We live in the worst timeline.
Congrats. Now to present the best mobile game, please welcome WNBA player and Team Liquid streamer, Ariel Powers.
Hmm? Oh, that's who this is? This is a WNBA player?
Thanks, Jeff.
Oh, she
Here
tall.
Are the nominees for best mobile game presented by Verizon. And the game award goes to
League of Legends.
Genshin Impact.
Genshin?
Oh. Stay right here.
Genshin Impact? Genshin Impact.
Whoa.
First you hit me with your self-advertisement, then Genshin. Genshin Impact. Freaking Gen Zers. I know all of you Gen Zers be playing Genshin Impact. Don't lie to me. I know you little Zoomers.
Hey. Oh
my God, I'm done. People are, I already know they're flaming her. It's over. She's getting flamed online right now. You had one job.
I know when things right now are very, very difficult. I know that things are all over the place in lots of different ways.
It's scary, man. I mean, it's
Jen,
just there's
like
no
J.
other way to put it. It is scary to be black in this country today.
I'm a black Gen. Mom, so
a lot of people in gaming communities just don't want to hear it.
We sat down for about 2 hours.
Congratulations.
Maybe we'll get some Primo gems because we won.
Oh, no, they already have.
Oh, yeah, I know they gave it for them being nominated, but now that they actually won, maybe we get more.
So the show goes up.
I need as much as possible.
So I would see all these.
Did that just say a lesson in blackness?
Hey, you need to check this out. Hey, you need to be paying attention to this.
Less.
And then one of the big outlets caught it.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't you fear. I, a fellow African American, will teach you how
to
be black.
Voice in a way that felt power.
Step one,
really
be born black.
Conversation about
Step two,
doing a show through a prison.
You're not black then.
I think we did the job in a
you're
really
welcome.
Good way. And I think the
you're
world
welcome,
and the industry was better for it.
I know you appreciated that very much.
When are you gonna play on Facebook?
When am I gonna what?
When are you gonna stream on
Facebook? I'm not streaming on Facebook Gaming. Yeah. 10,000 Primo Gems? Yeah, that'd be the day. Sheesh. I don't even have 10,000 Primo Gems saved up. I got like 8,000. We're back with some PUBG Mobile, guys. You know what's going on. PUBG, everybody's favorite battle royale game in 2021. Here we have exhilarating gameplay, grenades, frying pans, maybe even some zombies in there too to mix it up a little bit, mix up the genre. Everybody in the mother's gonna love PUBG. Your dad's gonna love PUBG. Your husband's gonna love PUBG. Maybe even your newborn baby's gonna love PUBG. We all love PUBG. PUBG can sponsor me, and I make some good money off of that. I love PUBG.
Oh,
is that good? Listen, somebody just click that and send that to PUBG. Maybe they'll sponsor me.
That's for collaboration.
We have a League of Legends collaboration for PUBG. Because we want to milk that, because we know everybody loves that Arcane show. PUBG Mobile.
With Amazon Luna, I can play all my favorite games straight from the cloud.
That's right. I can play on my Fire TV, tablet, and phone. Yo, Brandon, what's that game you keep talking about?
Which one? The lineup looks awesome.
It's Honey Pop, dude. I love that game. Oh, yeah, Yaku. I mean, yeah.
Rainbow Six Extraction?
Yeah, I meant that.
Any game without waiting for long downloads.
There are so many great games. Luna Couch, anyone?
I'm in. Feels like I'm on your couch.
Let's go.
What?
Said Honey Pop and Olka. I thought that's what he was gonna say. My bad.
Warhammer.
Am I looking at right now? What am I?
Blessed Sigma, the world drowns in corruption. Your empire is aflame with heresy. The faithful perish, and the wicked multiply. Blessed
Sigma. Damn, he got that nice bald head. Look at that thing. Man, if you just only looked at the top of his head, you might think it's like a bread, like a loaf of bread or something.
Just look at the nose, though. It looks like a Minecraft village.
I was too busy looking at that head.
By the comet and the hammer.
The hammer. To the
coming. Wait, he's bald? He has a long nose? He's definitely a villager in Minecraft.
Yeah.
Against the flames of perdition.
Damn, bro, what the
to drive back the shadow of
you're still dying because of Genshin. Genshin Impact, boys, you know what's going on at here. Hey, boy.
Where is your patience, Master Dwarf?
Have I ever let you down? No. But yeah, Chad, I know you guys love Genshin. The little Gen Zers. You little Zoomers. That woman got 5 IQ max. Well, listen. She got set up for failure. She's a WNBA player. She's very tall, you know. She out here dunking. Yeah, she ain't know nothing about that Genshin. Game for the cloud.
She's an actor who stars in The Mandalorian and the upcoming series, The Book of Boba Fett. Please
Boba
welcome
Fett?
Ming-Na Wen.
Let's go, Boba Fett. Yeah, Hellblade 2 looking like Attack on Titan out there.
A gaming narrative is more than a collection of cutscenes. It represents our own involvement with the story and its characters. To be nominated for the Best Narrative Award, a great game demands provocative dialogue and a captivating plot. But above all, it must exhibit a meaningful involvement with the audience. And also, just speaking as the mother of a son who loves gaming, it's nice when there's more to the story than just blowing up grenade factories and shouting obscenities at your alligator brides.
Oh.
Here are the nominees for Best Narrative.
I can relate. Gaming moms, am I right, chat?
Best channel. Narrative.
What do we have? What was the category? Narrative?
Yeah, narrative.
spell, I am telling you.
Based off what I've heard so far, it takes two.
I need to find out exactly what happened.
Oh, but you have Life is Strange up there. I don't know. People really, really praise it. Oh, no. Okay, wait. Guardians is up there. I know the story in that game is what carried that game like crazy. And just the interactions with the characters. My first day on the job. That's actually pretty tough. That's actually pretty tough. It takes two or Guardians.
The best narrative goes to... Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy.
I'm surprised. I mean, I knew the story was incredible, right? But I thought It Takes Two. That It Takes Two guy, I know he wanted to jump up there because every Game Awards he'd be talking on a microphone for like 20 minutes. Wow. Okay. I mean, I plan on playing this game, but okay. I mean, hey, Marvel writing.
Okay,
you think they about to lose?
There are so many people responsible for making this such a wonderful thing. I want to thank Marvel Game Studios for trusting us with their characters and for allowing us to make them our own, for our fabulous cast, for bringing them to life in ways that words on a page can never do. For Olivier, our producer, Hubert, JF, my game director, the entire crew who worked on it, and of course my wonderfully wild, wacky, immensely talented writers. Thank you for making comedy look easy. Thank you for not complaining too often when I pushed you to remember our main themes of grief and to go deeper. Who am I kidding? I know you complained, but thank you for not doing it to me. Thank you, everyone. This is an honor.
What's going on in there? It sounds like you are overworking your employees. I bet the crowd was getting scared. They were getting some Activision vibes for a second. Like, what? What is she saying? She had to clean that up real quick. That was about to get back. But, no, I'm happy about Guardians. Like I said, I heard the story, and I saw a little bit of the game just to see how the characters interacted, and it looked really good. Like, it felt like, oh yeah, this is how the Guardians of the Galaxy would really interact with each other, so good on them.
Are you gonna play this game, Val?
Damn, freaking Wind Waker flashbacks. You don't tell me this ain't Legend of Zelda Wind Waker? What the hell going on? Bruh. Oh, damn. Excuse me?
Damn.
Damn, I wish I could do that in Breath of the Wild. Why can't I do some somersaults? Ah, yeah, here's the difference. You turn into a bird. Then you jump out. Damn. Oh my god, I'm playing Gmod. Yeah, new game. Yeah, now you were inspired by something, all right. Prop hunt. Okay. PlayStation. Okay.
What a beautiful game. All right, now we have something very special. The gameplay world premiere trailer for Rocksteady's newest title, Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League.
Let's go.
We've all been waiting anxiously for them to give us a first look at...
Oh?
Kaylee! What the hell do you think you're doing? Huh? That footage is strictly classified.
Oh, she's gonna be Waller. She looking dead serious.
My name is director Amanda Waller. And since the Game Awards doesn't care about disclosing classified intel, listen up. Whatever you've heard about Task Force X, the state of the Justice League, or Superman rampaging through the streets of Metropolis, you better not say a word ever to anyone. Yes, ma'am. Because if you do, believe you me, I'll hear about it. You've all been warned. Waller out.
She did a really good job with that. That voice. That is a damn good voice.
She gone? She's gone. Good. All right. Well,
now she did that perfectly.
I think we waited long enough to see Rocksteady's new game. This is going to be worth the risk. You guys want to do it?
Yeah, let's see the Suicide Squad game, finally. Show me the gameplay for this.
When I think of the Justice League, I think of Wonder Woman, Superman, Green Lantern. You don't want to mess with that lot. But you, Barry, you're just the team mascot, aren't you, mate? The loser of the league, folks. The fastest man alive. It's the Flash.
Flash is alive, and he's playing for Team Brainiac.
I gave you orders. Kill the Flash, or I'll kill you myself.
Cool, cool.
Show me the gameplay. Come on. Let's see it.
Nothing can stop me.
Okay, my guy.
Dead shot.
Did you get him? Really? Why don't you just mail me the bullet?
Okay.
I'm the eye in the sky, taking point B, shark.
Pulverize.
Hey, it looks, that looks pretty crazy. Okay. A lot of shooting.
Gameplay is very interesting.
Yeah, and I think it's sort of what I heard a long time ago what the gameplay was going to be. A lot of shooting, which makes sense. But I'm seeing like some melee animations. I just hope there's some, like a decent amount of melee animations too. Because it looks like—
I like the movement.
Yeah, the movement looks good. It just looks like a lot of shooting.
No escape from my wrath.
You wanna see what a real hero can do? I'll show you. Come on then, ya prick!
This dude's throwing spirit bombs.
Really?
Kamehameha!
What the hell? Okay. Yeah, it looked like what I expected it to look like gameplay-wise. I mean, it could be fun with friends.
Upcoming game for Spoken. Here are the performers.
Some of the physics look
Ella
a bit
Balinska
funky.
And
yeah, they have.
Pollyanna McIntosh.
They got some time to mess with some stuff, right?
Hi.
Oh, this
I'm
game.
To be here with You may have met the character I portray in Forspoken, Frey Holland. I am so excited to be here to announce a brand new trailer, and especially delighted tonight as we will be seeing Pollyanna's first portrayal of Tanta Prav for the very first time.
She is a ruthless adversary for Frey, and I hope players get into it, looking for a boss fight with this woman at some point.
I definitely hope that you're in a boss fight.
Thank you, Ella. That's so kind.
She is so
Even
nervous.
If it is with Frey?
Especially if it's with Frey. And now, a world premiere trailer for Forspoken.
All right, let's see. Yeah, I remember seeing this game, like, some months and months back, huh?
Who are you, child?
My name is Frey Holland. I do not know how I got here. And all I want is to go home.
She is Hellspawn. How else did she survive in the corruption?
The people are afraid. They look to me in the council for hope that we cannot give them. But maybe you can.
Wherever I go turns to shit. It's always been this way.
Athia's all but lost.
Everything that corruption touches.
It breaks. Yeah, I saw it.
Isekai game.
It is you who trespassed on my land. You who set this.
Yeah, this is the game that the mobility looks pretty crazy. Listen, you've been transferred into another world that you've never been to before. It's scary, there's monsters, but there's no anime waifus. It's only violence and people hating you.
How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Lies! She dies!
What the hell?
What in the world?
Okay, man. She had that five head. Forspoken. She Will Rise, May 24th, 2022. Pre-order now. Oh yeah, he did that, dude. Don't worry, it's Master Chief. He's here to save you. Oh my god. Oh, no, that's not Master Chief. I'm sorry. It's Mega Man. Oh shit. Okay, that's not Mega Man. I'm... I'm fighting back. Yeah, this is the new Astro Boy game. They're taking a very different route. We're taking the Gears of War route, where we're gonna get chainsaw weapons. Damn, bro, he didn't even look at you.
Damn, he's fully pissed.
Damn, my guy got messed up. Warhammer Space Marine. Watch the game look nothing like that. Oh, damn, okay, wait a second. It actually does look like how they were showing it to be, huh? Looks like Gears of War on crack.
Joining me now is Tim Willits from Saber and the star of the game who will play Captain Titus, Clive Standen.
Oh my god,
Tim,
look at him.
What did we just see?
Well, I'm just so excited I can finally talk about this game. Yeah. You know, we are making Space Marine 2.
Doom.
The iconic, you know, Warhammer 40K game. You know, and at Saber, you know, we're using the experience that we have learned from games like Halo, Quake Champions, World War Z, to really bring this game to life, to make it the most intense action game ever. And we've got Clive as a Space Marine. It's awesome.
Clive, how does it feel to be in the game? Well,
it's a dream, a pretty bleak and grim dream, but anyone who's ever seen any of the work I've done, I'm not scared of the darkness. I'm stoked and grateful to be a part of this. I used to play with and paint the Space Marines when I was a kid with my older brother, so the chance to play one of the most iconic characters in the Warhammer 40K universe is everything to me. So
it fits you. Looks good. So yeah. We're excited to see more of the game, and awesome for you guys to show the gameplay. Tim, Clive, thank you so much for joining us. And right now, here's a brand new look at Saints Row.
Saints Row. Oh boy, I know people were heated about this Saints Row reboot. They were not happy.
Were they?
Yeah, they were. I saw people were really mad. Like back when dislikes still showed up, that like-dislike ratio was messy.
Oh, I guess they took this on Twitter.
Damn, it's Wolverine.
Who messes with the
Saints Row, ladies and gentlemen, 2021. I mean, 2022. I don't know. I'm just not feeling anything from it. Like, I'm just.
It just looks like another GTA.
Like, it just. I don't know. It doesn't do much for me. Guns.
Fuck you.
I don't know, like, it's not like some of the stuff doesn't look cool gameplay wise, it's just something about it, I don't know. It's just something about it just isn't intriguing to me.
GTA, right, but with mods.
Yeah.
It looks so like GTA 5.
I mean, Saints Row and GTA, they've always had their comparisons and stuff, but I don't know. It's just not intriguing to me. Oh, Nightmare Before Christmas. What the heck? Oh, no.
Oh, it's Fall Guy.
No. I haven't played this game in Lord knows how long. No. I'm not returning to this game. This game gave me bad memories.
We need to get the crown.
No. No. Fall Guys was such a bad time for me. Like...
Play the game again.
No, I don't want to play this game again. That game messed me up. That game really messed me up. Mm-mm. It seems like everybody's getting collaborations these days, huh?
Cuphead, oh,
Bomberman, Jubble Knight.
I saw a 2B.
Near? Kenna? Let's be good to Tsushima. This game's
like
still getting updates?
Well.
Yeah! What the hell, bruh?
There's still
oh my gosh! This is number 5, right? Hey guys, it's Nate Hill here, you know what I'm saying? I'm here with the WNBA player that said Genshin Impact earlier, and we out here self-promoting our Twitch channels, you know? Come check us out. But, hey! Hey, ain't no self-promo around here. Alright, sorry about that, chat.
Ah, yeah, it's Battlefield, the most glitchiest game.
Oh, yeah, I heard people hated that Battlefield. I'm gonna save our ears.
Dashing through the snow, with a bunch of ads your way. Genshin Impact goes. Winning mobile game. Can this ad just end? If it doesn't anytime soon, I'm gonna run out of things to say, so can we just go move? Oh. Ads.
Get out of here, get out of here.
Ads, please go away.
It's not
oh my
so
god,
fun
they're showing
here,
more. It's phase rug. Oh, please go away.
We don't want your sponsors.
It's please so stop horrible. This right now. Oh, God. Are we done?
You're ruining the entire show.
Making it burn to the ground.
Oh, I think it's fine right here.
Did you enjoy that performance, chat? Was that good? Paul George! Oh my god, it's playoff P! Holy crap! Only people who watch basketball are gonna get that reference.
The gold medal. Was that enough? Nah.
Actually, they call him Pandemic
one title enough.
That's what they be calling him.
Nope.
Basically, if you don't know why they call him Pandemic P, it's because in the playoffs, he ends up sucking really bad and ends up choking for his team.
You only want more.
So... That's because why they call them playoff people.
It's never enough.
Just so if you were wondering. Talk about some squeaky audio.
To present our next award, it's the man you just saw in that WD Black piece, and tonight you can get 10% off selected WD Black products to celebrate the Game Awards. Please welcome seven-time NBA All-Star and owner of Endemic, Paul George.
You got any rings, though? Ask him if he has any championships. I'm like the people on Twitter and Instagram that be flaming Paul George. What a joke.
Good evening, everyone.
I'm not chill.
I love action-adventure games for their versatility. One minute, you're solving a puzzle. The next, you're lining up headshots. And then suddenly, you're being put on a hook by a vampire lady taller than me. This category is like a showcase of what it means to be a video game. Here are the nominees for Best Action-Adventure Game.
Bro, you only play Call of Duty and 2K, don't you lie? I know what you be playing. So this is Best Action-Adventure Game? Okay, Guardians, Metroid Dread, okay. I'm gonna give it to Dread right now. I've got eyes on the target. Ratchet, Oh damn. The action in that was. Oh damn. Okay, I don't know. I can't answer this one. I can't answer this. Anything could honestly.
And the game award for best action adventure game goes to.
Goes to.
Dread.
Metroid Dread.
Okay.
Let's go.
I'm cool with that. Dread deserves that. It had a very, very good action. Adventure. Oh. I like that. It's Bowser.
On behalf of the teams at Nintendo and Mercury Steam who worked on Metroid Dread, thank you so much for this award and congratulations to all the other nominees. This is the action adventure category, and Metroid Dread checks off both the action and the adventure box.
Mm-hmm.
It's filled with action-packed moments behind every door, around every corner, and on every level.
Hearing?
And at the same time, it introduces us to a massive and mysterious new planet that players can explore and adventure through. It's the result of a true collaboration between Nintendo and Mercury Steam, and I have a few comments that the developers asked me to read on their behalf. We'd like to say a big thank you for this award from the development teams at Nintendo and Mercury Steam that worked so hard to bring all the Metroid fans around the world the experience that they were hoping for. It's been a dream come true to travel together in this dangerous yet marvelous journey to ZDR. We're so thankful for all the fans for enjoying Metroid Dread on Nintendo Switch. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
There it is. The biggest death trap in all history. And the Duke's headed into its jaws.
On Caladan, we ruled with air and sea power. Here, we must scrabble for desert power.
Move slowly, and the day of your revenge will come.
This is your inheritance.
Oh, is this Dune?
The device of Shaitan.
What, Dune?
There will always be a desert on
Arrakis. What, they got a Dune video game?
To become the Baron Vladimir Hart.
Is that what that is?
Everything happens to me.
Your enemy was overwhelming.
You'll not be irrelevant.
Yet you know
that.
We Fremen have a saying. God created Arrakis to train the faithful.
Arrakis.
To hold Arrakis, you're faced with
Arrakis. Arrakis is our enemy.
This is what? My future.
This is my honor.
This is my vengeance. This is my doom.
Spice Bro. So they really made a Dune video game.
The moment I saw it, Dragonfly Beck, oh my god, it's Dune.
A Dune strategy
Please
game.
Welcome two of the stars of the upcoming Tiny Tina's Wonderland.
Oh, Borderlands.
Ashley Burch and Will Arnett. Oh, what's up, baby girls? Thank you for having us. We are so excited to reveal a bit about the story in Tiny Tina's Wonderlands.
Yeah. Respectfully,
are we talking about the Dragon Lord yet?
Anyways.
Yes, Will plays the Dragon Lord, the central villain within the Wonderlands.
Yes, but in a clever twist, I turn out to be the underdog hero of the entire realm, and it's really beautiful. And it's actually one of the main reasons that I took this role, so.
Oh, it's the Lego guy.
No.
What do you mean, no?
You play a necromantic overlord, and not the good kind.
Well, he's a job creator for millions of unemployed individuals.
He raises the dead, man.
Yeah, and he gives them stuff to do, okay? Some of them get to sail. Some form a rock band. A lot of them, like, I don't know, stab things or something.
Do you really not know the story of the game that you're in?
Sure, no. You mean the whimsical adventure from the mind of a 13-year-old demolitions expert? Yeah, who whimsically tries to blow up the heroes for 40 levels? Yeah, so if anyone is the central villain here, it's Tiny Tina.
All right, roll the damn trailer.
There is a world beyond the Borderlands.
Oh my.
A world forged by wonder and ruled by fate. There's
it's
one alone who can wield fate. One alone whose story is in their own hands. The Fate Maker. That's you. Heavy, right?
Okay.
You seek passage. I can aid you.
I am Valentine, gallant adventurer. The scary stabby one is Fret.
Of course.
Fall beneath our blades.
I'm sensing some real evil vibes this way. Now follow me.
Oh my god, the homie.
A beautiful body indeed. And full of power.
I'm invincible.
Looking bad. How do we win this?
We attack together.
Whoa, who would have thought of that?
You'll never get the sword of souls, Chewie, idiot.
You want a fight? I'll give you a fight.
That's a big boy. That's a big, big boy.
Sisters, I believe we have found our champion.
Oh, listen to me, lip flapping while you could be off adventuring.
Tina, you left a cheese curl on the board.
Mayhaps it is a powerful ancient meteor, and it begins to rise from the ground.
Oh my god.
It's a blessing.
Definitely.
It's a blasting!
Yeah, this is probably gonna end up being good. See, when Borderlands does stuff like this, it's good. Borderlands 3, the base game, was not good. But I just heard that the DLC for Borderlands 3 was good. But this, yeah. It's what Borderlands does best. Weird stuff. That doesn't feel forced. Freaking Tiny Tina, dude.
All right. Last year, one indie game won multiple game awards, and now they're back in a totally new, unexpected way.
What you mean? What you talking about, Jeff? What is this, Jeff?
It does this look like Simpson or Futurama?
Looks like Rick and Morty or some crap, right?
Yeah. Oh, is this Among Us? No. No.
VR Among Us. Yeah, I really want to feel like I'm getting stabbed. Nothing like stabbing people in VR, right?
Like the
really
moment.
Fun. All right, tonight we have a very special K-pop performance. The South Korean developer Pearl Abyss wanted to thank you for the great response to their recent trailer.
It's the game that I reacted to the trailer, and I got a bunch of people angry for some reason.
So they created a music video working with the popular K-pop dance team.
Chat, you know what happened with this game? Studio. I reacted to this game, and I didn't see any adults in the game. So I'm like, where are the kids' parents? I was making jokes. And then the people that were Korean, they're like, did you not know that in Korea we actually have like it's safe for kids to be out there without their parents? And I'm like, that's a real thing.
I mean, it's a cultural thing, though.
I didn't know that it was that safe over there. I don't know anything about Korea. How was I supposed to know kids roam the streets without their parents? No, this song isn't copyright. This is the same exact song that they played in the original trailer.
Though it reminds me of that.
Is that what you want to change? There you go. Damn, bro. I could do those moves. They about to hit them Zoomer TikTok dances real quick. I think I could do it. I mean, the game itself actually looks cool. I will say that. Like, I know they're doing this weird performance. Like, you know, they're doing this performance right now. But, like, I'm telling you, the actual gameplay in the game is crazy from the first trailer. Like, it's all over the place, but like in a cool way. You said dance, Keith? Yeah, you like the moves. I know, my moves are clean. No, you don't like their smiles. They had enough. Damn, bro. I'm about to stand up. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not standing up, bro. I haven't
like I see the fat on the side
up in a while, but let me stretch my freaking legs, bro. Woo! It's Dokken.
All night we are wrapping up 2021 with Spotify, and here for the first time are the top three male and female artists as listened
to by you
on gaming consoles in 2021. Top female artists: Doja Cat, Billie Eilish, and Ariana Grande. Top male: Juice WRLD, XXX Tentacion, and
Tentacion.
Polo G.
Later, Polo G.
The most listened to Spotify songs. Now, a winner Polo earlier
G.
tonight.
Who the hell be listening to my Polo G?
Here's a look at two new characters coming December 14th to Genshin Impact, and the first glimpse of the upcoming character Yeonjin.
Yeonjin.
Genshin reaction. Pog.
Yeonjin.
Father.
The sky is clear and the sun is shining.
Hey!
Kabuto out for some training.
It's our boy.
I'm the one who's supposed to be adored by the kids. Me!
Not if I have anything to say about it. To survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship.
Keep your weapon at the ready. You never know what's around the corner.
You know, gotta love Genshin Impact, like the lady said. Oh my god, it's the dog that I have to fight over and over again to get the materials I need.
Hold the line.
Go crazy out there, you got it.
Charge! Let's roll!
Alright, you don't carry.
Rally!
Goro. Damn, look at Ito go. Ito thooming. That voice acting, man. Max Middleman. Legendary.
Huh?
Oh, okay. He's gonna. They're like, nah, we'll save it for our own trailer. We'll give her our own little thing. Sorry. Water Girl got you acting up. What, Kokomi?
He is a proponent of a theory called animal magnetism. He's capable of anything.
Well, this there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Your Genshin.
It could do much more than dance.
Angel of Death. Is this the Pinocchio one?
What is this? Is this?
It looks like Pinocchio one.
Yeah, is this the Pinocchio Bloodborne game?
These machines. No, there's no way.
The greater the massacre, the deeper the river where they slake their thirst.
I think this one's different.
They just making puppet games now?
Similar puppet game, for some reason.
Yeah, Is puppets the new wave? I guess so.
Yeah, that's not it.
Yeah, that's not the Pinocchio Bloodborne Dark Souls game. What the hell? Hey everybody, make sure you get your G Fuel, you get your Red Bull, you get your Monster Energy, and you come by these gaming processors. You're gonna be looking like a beast out here, don't worry, and play Among
What's
Us
up,
in
everyone?
VR.
This is Matt Hafey, lead guitar player and lead singer of the metal band Trivium. I'm also a streamer on Twitch. I'm stoked to announce that I'm in Metal Hellsinger, a rhythm-based shooter game. Make sure you check it out. We also have incredible metal screamers.
Sounds like a copyright
like myself,
claim.
Like Alyssa from Arch Enemy, Randy from Lamb of God. Check it out, my friends. I will see you all in hell.
This just sounds like a copyright claim, so I'm just gonna mute it. When you say a rhythm-based, you know, music, I mean, what was it? Shooter, rhythm game, something crap? I don't remember. Listen, you mentioned music or some crap. I gotta freaking mute it. Not the Twitch streamers, or the Twitch streamers been here all night. The girl who said Genshin Impact, you know, she's a WNBA player, but she streams too, if you didn't know that by the fifth time she said it. Yeah, we've had quite a bit of things like that.
She's unfamiliar with the term Genshin and then turn it to Genshin.
Yeah, I'm not gonna take my chance with this audio. Yeah, these are actual songs, aren't they? Yeah, I'm not gonna mess with that. We'll just have that muted. Yeah, I think, like, I bet you if I go on Twitter, Genshin Impact is probably trending. I have to see this. Give me a sec. I haven't looked at social media the whole time.
World on the Spider-Man.
Oh my god, it's Rocket League!
Is this the time-traveling one? No.
Don't know if this is copyright, so I'm gonna stop it for a sec. Oh yeah, 360 tweets for Genshin. Genshin Impact, we did it, boys. Oh my god, Genshin Impact memes changed their name to Genshin. Oh my god. Then people saying Primo's win. Oh yeah, that's great. You thought that people couldn't mispronounce any mispronounce that any worse, but here we are. Yeah, no, something. It was great. I mean, yeah, there's been some good announcements tonight, but I'm still wanting. They need to give me Wolf Among Us Season 2. I'm gonna be upset. They better give me my Wolf Among Us. Don't think I forgot. I haven't. Who's hopping in an Among Us VR lobby with you? Not me. All right.
Welcome back, and that's right. Starting in 2022, there's a new way to play your favorite mobile games on your PC through Google Play Games. Take games from your pocket to your desktop and seamlessly pick up where you left off. Google Play Games on PC is coming soon in 2022. Next, here's another brand new game announcement for the first time at the Game Awards.
Brand new. Brand new. You want Ark News? I don't know if you're going to get it. Man, where's Breath of the Wild 2 at? I enlisted because Telltale?
Batman. Years just to get Walking out and Dead. See the galaxy. I wanted to go somewhere, see new worlds, look up at a sky no one's ever seen before. There's so many space games. Come on, man.
Another space game that was made by Telltale people. Become a captain someday. Star Trek.
We need to learn everything we can. You're not gonna die. Not if I have anything to say about it. This. Can't be right.
Aren't they making a new Mass Effect game? Impact, 1 minute. Pretty sure they are. This is some damn Star Trek, bro. I need you to do the right thing. Isn't that the Star Trek logo?
It is probably Star Trek.
And I do ugly. Yeah, that's Star Trek. Of the Federation and
the prospect for peace. Yep, that's definitely him.
Like, listen, if you like Star Trek, you do your thing. But my interpretation is the people that like Star Trek, I feel like they're pretty old at this point. Am I wrong with saying that, Rose? I don't know anybody my age that likes Star Trek. Make some noise for Reggie. Star Wars, yeah, Star Wars, of course. But Star Trek, I don't know. Reggie, the homie.
Thank you, thank you. Wow. You know, Jeff said it earlier. Isn't
my body
is
ready.
Be back live and in person, back amongst friends. It's fantastic. This is a wonderful time of the year. The Game Awards. Our opportunity to celebrate the creators and the players. What is this, Jeff? Eighth year? Something like that? So much, you know, we've witnessed so much over these past few years. The launch of next generation 8 and 9 consoles, the mobile revolution, streaming games, VR, AR, and quality free-to-play games. And this category represents another innovation in our industry. This is the award for best ongoing game. It used to be that a game would ship, and that would be the game. But today's developers keep players coming back to their beloved titles again and again by delivering and creating exciting new content. Here are the 5 nominees who are engaging their audiences year after year.
Fortnite's gonna win!
Apex Legends. Call of Duty, no. All right.
Yeah, Fortnite.
Fortnite's probably gonna win. Oh no, the Final Fantasy.
Actually, Final Fantasy.
Final Fantasy's up there. It's gonna be between. Oh, Genshin's up. Ooh. Oh, this is a tough one. Oh man, who are they gonna give that to?
Genshin or Fortnite?
Genshin or Fortnite's gonna win that.
And the game award for the best ongoing game goes to
Fortnite.
Final Fantasy.
Oh, Final Fantasy, yeah.
I mean, I'm happy for them, but they beat Fortnite and Genshin.
Tonight, Final Fantasy 14 Online also wins.
Wow.
Best community support.
They deserve
good
it.
For them. I know that those people put in a bunch of work. Good for them.
Clear win victory.
I'm not mad at them.
I mean, Genshin already had it.
Yeah, Genshin already won a category earlier.
This is quite the honor to win Best Ongoing Game. The category had so many amazing nominees that it's truly fortunate that we were able to win. There's an incredible team behind Final Fantasy XIV who pour their hearts into the work, bringing new and memorable stories and adventures to our fans, from A Realm Reborn all the way to Endwalker and beyond. So a big thank you to Final Fantasy XIV team, and can't wait to see what's going on in the future. And honestly, the biggest thanks to our community. They've been our rock, and we're so happy that you continue to give us our support. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that was... I'm happy for them. Good for them. World premiere. What is it? Epic Games Publishing.
And there goes my baby brother in the back.
Acting like a crackhead.
Since the dawn of time, we've been
Flintstone.
Isn't that the perfect time? My baby brother wants to scream in the back. We see some cavemen.
As civilization evolved, so did the desire for battle and the drive to be the best. Cities grew, and soon everyone wanted a piece of the action.
Interesting.
Some for power, some fame, but many just love the thrill of the fight. Even today. Oh, come on!
The hell?
What in the world is that?
I don't know. All right, we've got a battle royale where everybody just punches each other. Yeah, it's Fortnite too, except they just punch you. What? All right, we're making this a WWE outside fight. All right, street fight. All right, that's legit what this is. This is just a street fight.
Yeah, it's like Dino Club Rescue.
What the hell? Bro, this dude did not just climb up the building like that. He looked like Boss Baby. Damn, my guy already.
Is that you, Vel? You're short?
What the hell? I don't remember being that big. He said, damn, bro. Man got punched in the stomach. Oh, no. He's gonna fall off the building. What? Damn, she gonna hit him with a German suplex? He's dead. They're both dead.
Rumbleverse.
Is that what I said? Rumbleverse? I said believers. Rumbleverse. Battle Royale, everybody punching each other. Okay.
That was Rumbleverse coming next year from Iron Galaxy and Epic Games. And tomorrow, there's a first look gameplay event. Head to rumbleverse.com to sign up.
You should have just showed us the gameplay today.
The gameplay debut of a sequel to a Game Awards nominee from a few years ago, A Plague Tale Requiem.
It sounded like a whole pay-per-view. A Plague Tale. That's the game with the rats.
Under the wide and starry sky. Dig the grave.
No waiting for Breath of the Wild 2.
I'm waiting for Wolf Among Us 2, okay? I've been waiting like 8 years, Rez. I need this.
Come, Hugo. I'm right behind you.
Glad did I live and gladly die. And I laid me down. With a will.
Impossible.
It's rats.
This be the verse you crave.
It's Ratatouille, but the rats don't know how to cook.
You've seen worse than this.
Here he lies, where he longed to be. Home is the sailor. Home.
Oh yeah, you missed Sonic, yeah.
And
in
the hunter,
DLC.
Home from the hill.
Give me them legs. I'm turning into a rat.
I know. Think of your brother.
I'm thinking of Remy. Holy rats, bro.
What have you done?
Damn, is that Ganon? Holy crap. She's turning British. If you don't like rats, you're gonna hate that game too.
This year, we partnered with Grubhub to do something really cool to get your food delivered for the Game Awards. Order Grubhub.
Oh, is it bad that every time I hear the name Grubhub, I think of that dude with the glasses and him dancing and like his belly going all over?
We got lots of shows still to go. This year, Techland celebrated its 30th anniversary, and next year, Dying Light 2 arrives after a long wait. We've got a new look right now at the game's story.
Dying Light, we're actually seeing some gameplay from the sequel. I forgot Dying Light 2 was even coming out. It got delayed, didn't it? Like again and again.
Yeah, it keeps delaying.
Yeah, that cyberpunk treatment. Huh. Everybody loves their zombie parkour. I mean, Dying Light 1 is so old. I played it when I was like a little Timothy. Like, I was so young.
I've seen the gameplay a lot.
I was a little kid.
I've been waiting for Dying Light 2.
Come here. You can have fun. There's no fun allowed here.
Not to hell. Come. Come.
They won't like the pink, trust me.
What
the pink is gone.
Shit. You bastard.
Ooh,
that got hurt.
Get off me. I need this. Oh, damn. Oy! Oh yeah, they really don't like the pink.
Wait for me.
Damn, bro.
Rest in peace.
Everybody getting body. Oh, okay. February 4th? Okay. I mean, I'd get the game just because I played Dying Light 1 and I liked how the gameplay was. Parkour zombie killing crap. Cool. Okay. Yeah.
Hello. It's Master Chief here. And, no, I'm just kidding.
I'm just kidding. Two, one, blast off. Watch it get delayed again? It wouldn't surprise me. We're going down. Where are we landing, boys? Nothing too crazy about what I'm seeing right now. It looks like a Call of Duty campaign. Freaking Battlefield. That's the issue when you make a shooter, though. You know, you really got to do something unique with it, or it just sort of falls into that category.
Every shooter game is similar.
Yeah. You better say that game looks like... too much like Evolve. Oh, you remember Evolve? I remember Evolve. That game flopped. Holy crap. I remember Evolve. Oh my gosh. It's Call of Duty guy. Okay. Dang, now this is a real shooter.
Oh, yeah. Third person shooter. Has flipped.
I already know what they're about to show, too. Welcome to I have my guess. Where there are brand new places to explore and exciting new ways to experience Fortnite like never before. Listen, guys. Start by earning battle pass. Y'all want some good old characters in Fortnite, and guess what? We got some exclusive characters coming to Fortnite. Including Spider-Man. And it's Marcus Phoenix from Gears of War. More quickly and invade enemy fire with new sliding. The sliding is actually very good, I will say. And even set up camps where you and your squad can heal. I mean, this season, I will say the season's actually good. It is.
But it struggles again to win.
Oh no! The Game Awards froze on me. I gave Fortnite a compliment. Oh, this is the first time it froze. Oh hell no. Yeah, let me just go back a few seconds. Start by earning Battle Pass XP beyond Battle Royale. It said, my favorite weapon Battle Pass outfits in this season. The sniper rifle, because I actually have a sniper again. Also new features
to check out. Yeah, that's good. Get around more quickly
and invade enemy fire. I actually have a sniper again. And swinging. And even set up camps where you and your squad can heal and store items. From match to match. Big pogs.
Plus, there are new weapons and items to help win a victory royale.
Victory royale.
Ultimate prestige. The victory crown. Keep winning and keep the crown.
Yeah, the shotguns suck, but I think that's what the purpose. They're really trying to push the spray meta in the game. Because if you notice, the ARs are freaking yoked. Freaking cracked. Like crazy. Them ARs kill you. You have 200 health, you're dead like that. It's terrifying. But the shotguns, they're not definitely not as good.
I do like the new AR. They have the red pointers.
Yeah, and they shred you to pieces so fast. Chapter 3 Season 1 Battle Pass. That features Spider-Man, the Foundation. I can't wait for Relax to buy me the movie version of Spider-Man when he comes out. Drop into Chapter 3 and start exploring the new island, because you'll never know what you might find. Fortnite Chapter 3, mate, you know? Zombie game. I know what this game is. Masquerade, Blood Hunt.
Isn't this, like, basically... Wolves and vampires and another one.
Mm-hmm. It is. Have they not just implemented the weather yet? Yeah, they haven't done it yet.
This is basically Twilight, but Battle Royale.
Yeah, Twilight Battle Royale. Honestly, surprised that Nintendo hasn't pulled up yet. Yeah. I mean, maybe they're saving Breath of the Wild too. They'll be like, gameplay, guys, here you go. I don't know. Metroid. Prime 4. Isn't it? Is it 4? Or is it 3? The people. Which one is it, Rez?
Is it
the new Metroid Prime game that everybody wants really bad? Is it? I feel like it's 4.
Four?
It's 4. Bella went off here. Yeah, I know, right? We got like 38 minutes left of this thing. It's 4, yeah.
It's been a great year so far for Shark Mob on their first game, Blood Hunt. They just completed a successful early access, and I'm very excited for their full release next year. Blood Hunt will be out on PS5 and PC in spring 2022 and will be free to play. Back when I started the Game Awards in 2014, this band made a bet on me and the show, and few believe we could make the Game Awards a reality. 7 years later, Imagine Dragons is back at the Game Awards for a once-in-a-lifetime performance that celebrates 10 years of Supergiant Games and their first release, Bastion. Please welcome Imagine.
Imagine that copyright claim. Oh boy. Well, we're not gonna do that, chat, because we're gonna get hit with a real nasty copyright claim, like a disgusting one. So instead, we'll listen to music I have.
Really, bro? The same one?
Yes, I like this song. It's a very nice song. Just imagine that she's singing this. Damn, she going crazy right now, bro.
It looks so perfectly timed.
Yeah, what was it?
Damn, that man has a family voice.
Yeah. He's going crazy. So how long are they gonna sing for? Like 5 minutes? Listen, chat, they better show me Wolf Among Us 2 today. They better show it to me. They showed another Telltale game that was brand new. They better show me Wolf Among Us. I like how people for the Persona 4 Ultimax thing on PlayStation, they're like, yeah, we would have liked Persona 4 Golden on PlayStation. Ah, somebody on Instagram said Wolf Among Us 2 on the Telltale Instagram. And they said, yes, that's a game, and it's being worked on. Damn, so I don't think we're going to get Wolf Among Us. Based off of that answer, I don't know. I feel like they wouldn't have even responded if Wolf Among Us 2 was going to show up today.
Too bad.
He's still going?
I need to censor it.
Man, he's still going? Oh,
man.
Damn, bro. I'll play another song. Oh, they gave me an ad. Well, chat seems
like... I know.
Oh,
what song are you going to play?
it's a Shin Megami Tensei song.
Oh.
Oh, it's Jin! What the hell? They got Jin in there and I can't even listen to it? Aw, man. I know who that is. That is a rapper that I actually listen to quite a bit. He's actually really good. He raps like very, very quickly. I didn't know he was on an Imagine Dragon song. What the hell? I can't even listen to Jin, bro. That's a big rip. I'm sorry, man. Look, he's rapping fast right now, too. See, they're going crazy. Yeah. Okay, now he's doing the typical rapper thing that they do. Oh my god, they just smushed the cake in my face. I need to get the cake out of my eyes. That's what I call that maneuver. That's what he's doing right now. Somebody, it was his birthday, and they smashed the cake into his face. Keith SMT3, when? I gotta beat 5 first if, you know, my internet wants to let me. Damn, now they're watching this without any context. I don't know what's going on here. Damn, they are. They're going crazy. He told him, you gotta go to bed. You've been up too late, Jin. It's time to go to sleep. You gotta go. He's like, oh man. I guess you're right, man. And then that's what happened. Alright, you're welcome, chat. I think I did a good job with that. Alright, we done? Beautiful performance, I like that.
Oh my god, there that we is go. So great. Thank you to Imagine Dragons, JID, and good Ashley Barrett and Darren Korb. That's something you will only see at the Game Awards. Tonight, we partnered with Chevrolet to make the Game Awards live stream more accessible, including an audio descriptive stream, ASL stream with Deaf Gamers TV on Twitch, and closed captions. It's important. And now, to present the Innovation and Accessibility Award, please welcome Jacksepticeye and a member of our future class from 2020.
Somebody that I actually like. Oh my god.
For accessibility, the incredible Morgan Baker.
How about Markiplier?
Could make it, I guess. Damn, he got that all black.
Thank you, Jack. It's an honor to be here tonight. Games are for everyone. And this award recognizes the teams that are advancing gameplay, features, and technology to make sure games can be accessed and played by all.
It's incredible to see the effort developers put into prioritizing people who often go ignored, sharing their work with as many people as possible. And that's why we love being able to show our gratitude to those who go above and beyond each year, discovering new and creative methods to encourage inclusion. Here are the nominees.
Innovation and Accessibility, presented by Chevrolet.
Okay, so the game that helps the most for people that have disabilities.
Update that will be coming shortly after launch, players will be able to enable a sign language interpreter.
No way, that's not gonna be fun. Or Ratchet and Clank.
Escort the blind girl 500 miles down a treacherous valley on the way to an invading host.
I don't know, probably Forza.
Yeah,
I mean, it's presented by Chevrolet.
The Game Award for Innovation in Accessibility goes to...
probably Forza.
Forza Horizon 5.
When you have an award presented by Chevrolet, which is a car company, you think
tonight,
they're not going to win?
Forza Horizon 5 also
come on.
Best sports slash racing game.
This award means so much to our team because everyone at Playground Games is really committed to accessibility, so much so that we made it one of our core pillars for Forza Horizon. Around the world, there are about 1 billion players who have some sort of disability that makes gaming a challenge for them. And I think it's great that us as developers and as creators can add in accessibility features and options and just open the magic of video games to more and more players. I'd like to thank a few people. I'd like to thank Alan Hartman, Matt Booty, Tara Volker, Ben Williams.
Oh yeah, the homie Matt Booty, I know about
Team Xbox, as well as our accessibility champs, Tanya, Aaron, and Ryan. And with that, I'll go because it's telling me to wrap it up. When everyone plays, we all win.
Man, you say get off the stage. That's messed up, but they said we running out of time.
What a great sentiment.
Why does this guy look so depressed over here?
Congratulations, guys. All right, well, joining me now is Simon Vicklin from 10 Chambers. Simon, back in 2017, we announced your studio and your first game at GTFO right here at the Game Awards, and we're thrilled to have you back. I understand tonight you've got a special announcement for everyone?
Yes. It was a great opportunity to show off the game. Was it 4 years ago?
Yeah.
And
something's about to happen tonight, I think,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes, indeed. The thing is, it helped us reach, you know, the audience for our extreme co-op horror game.
Yes.
And we thought, what better way to announce 1.0?
Yeah.
We've been in early access now for 2 years. What better way to announce 1.0 than to come back to the Game Awards? So the surprise announcement is that GTFO is out now. This very minute, we release it right now.
Someone pressed a button.
Exactly. Back home in Sweden, someone's pressing a button right now.
Amazing.
And it's out now, and there's no better time to get into GTFO than right now, with 25% off, and you know, we worked hard to make the game more accessible.
Yeah.
Sorry, more accessible. And yeah.
Well, let's take a look. We've let's got take
this man a nervous show. Wreck
all
out
right,
there.
1.0 GTFO. Thanks so much, Simon. Check it out.
He is nervous. Understandably so. Oh, so these are the people that made Payday 2? Well, Payday and Payday.
Oh, it's... You know what it is.
I know what this is.
I forgot.
To make us new ones.
Is it Back for Blood?
No, this is completely different. Underground complex. This isn't Back for Blood now. This is their own game.
Wait a minute. Every resource scavenged.
Might give you one more chance. There's only one rule.
I think I noticed.
Bring it what it wants.
Yeah, we're behind on the stream because at some point it ended up lagging, so I just made it go back for a sec. So that is why we are behind a little bit. Wait. Compared to like people watching it in other places.
Yeah, I know this game.
Oh, wait a second. I feel like I remember seeing a trailer for this game a long time ago or something. Like something clicked in my head for a second.
I've seen people play the beta.
They deserve such hell.
It is really good.
All we know is we'll have to work together. Or we'll die together.
Ooh, that's a big boy.
Bro, we could play this game. But we need two other people.
Lord. Out now. Okay, I could probably move forward now. Yep, thought as much. Okay, we should be completely back up to date. I knew they were showing like commercial type stuff. Proud sponsor of the Game Awards. Don't need to play weird audio. Oh, zero copyright concerts. Okay, thank you, concerts. Yeah, thank you. No copyright stuff, so I could actually let this play. Nice.
Raid Shadow Legends.
God. They even got Jeff.
You pick your champions. They're glorious, and their shields. Oh, they glisten like. Wet otters, but the bad guys, they're Lovecraftian, they're spooky, they're big. And then you go to battle.
Raid like, Shadow Legends.
Then finally, your foe is vanquished, and that satisfaction is such a primal feeling.
Jeff Goldblum.
Download Raid Shadow Legends. Get exclusive free bonus pack with TGA 2021
Raid
promo code.
Raid Shadow Legends. You know, I assume somebody has to be playing a lot of Raid Shadow Legends for them to be giving all these people money. Chat, we got any raiders in here? Y'all be playing that Raid Shadow Legends. Don't lie to me. Somebody's got to be playing it. Who'll be doing it? Who'll be playing it? Let me know. You can tell me. It's okay.
To strike.
Raiders unite, what the hell? Raiders unite. Well, the Game Awards, we got like, well, like 23 more minutes, some crap. Ow, wow. Damn. That thing hurt. Alright, we just getting the ads out of the way, I see. Well, hopefully we go out with a bang here, huh? You know?
We protect humanity, whatever the cost.
Halo Infinite.
This wasn't the mission.
The missions change. They always do.
Yeah, I need to find Cortana. I miss her. I'm lonely.
Pass the ship to waifu.
Yeah, she's just a side piece, I swear, Cortana. I would never make her the main. That's basically what's going on.
You are not the future.
You are the past. Master Chief, how old even are you now?
It's enough.
Halo Infinite, available now.
Play it now with Game Pass.
Halo Infinite launched yesterday, and I know I'm playing it this weekend, and I am excited to watch next year when Steven Spielberg's Amblin Television, Showtime, and 343 Industries bring the legendary Master Chief to life in the live-action Halo original series streaming exclusively on Paramount+. Mm-hmm. Here is the world premiere first look trailer.
At the Master Chief TV show we're going in, if you can handle it.
You're special.
Damn.
In fact, I'm counting on it. We're lost in the dark. But you give people hope.
Damn, isn't that the guy from Spider-Man?
And I will always be with you.
Freaking shocker or something?
I see this. A new beginning.
Wait, just getting a movie?
He's getting a TV show.
Oh.
Yeah, Master Chief will be simping for Cortana on the big screen.
Very
Please
nice.
Welcome the Chief Creative Officer from Epic Games, Donald Mustard.
Hey, yo, Mustard. What's up, my guy?
That was crazy. That was amazing. All right. So making games that are original, innovative, and really push the medium forward is not easy at all. It's the culmination of the work and the talent of hundreds and hundreds of people and countless hours. And it only happens when there's a clear, shared vision of what a game can be. These nominees for Best Game Direction represent what's possible when it all comes together.
Not gonna lie, this is the best I've seen Mustard's hair look. Look better than last year and the year before.
Sure I do. Freedom.
Are you ready?
Alright, what category is this? What is it, direction or something?
I don't remember.
Chat, what category is this? Was anybody paying attention?
And I'm the new intern.
This is the part where you lose.
Yeah, guess best game direction. I was right. Okay.
Oh, so awesome.
All it right, takes
and the
two.
Award for best yes. game direction goes to.
Takes two.
Definitely. Damn, that It Takes Two guy looks like he wants to punch somebody. He mad as hell. You saw him ball up his fist.
Oh my god.
He's like, I didn't win jack out here. I flew all the way out here.
Yeah, so Deathloop is my first game as a game director, and it's also the first game that Sebastian and I are co-creative director for.
And, yeah, he's salty. Yeah, he big so, yeah,
I don't mean that as a brag. It was terrifying. Terrifying for us, terrifying for the team.
My guy, I look like he's in Deathloop.
So, yeah, that damn I really want to thank the
look, he's about to go out there team, and assassinate somebody.
For, you know, taking the leap of faith of giving their best work to make this strange game that no one can sum up in 30 seconds, you know, actually work. And yeah, and also thank you to PlayStation. You believed in our vision. Thank you to our fans. And actually, I have a lot of people to thank, but not a lot of time. Can we make those 30 seconds loop? A couple of times?
For Fortnite.
Okay. Okay, well,
am I going to say Fortnite? Listen, mustard.
Give me a small last word for my family in French. So, Lilia, Aya, Papa, Maman, je vous aime très fort. Merci. Thank you very much.
All right, my guy, I know you be killing people. I know what be going on.
Now it's time to take a look at some other award winners tonight. In the category of Best Esports Game, presented by Grubhub, here are the nominees.
Grubhub.
And the Game Award League goes to League of Legends.
Yeah, I gotta tell you that. Fortnite, Mustard 2020. He's like, I gotta talk about Fortnite. Deathloop Fortnite.
And the Game Award Mario goes Party. To It Takes Two.
Okay.
Here are the nominees for Best Fighting Game.
Oh,
and the Game
Guilty
Award
Gear?
Goes to... Guilty Gear.
I was gonna say that better go to Guilty Gear. If I would have went to Nickelodeon, I would have jumped.
Game. Here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to
Flight Simulator.
Age of Empires 4. Next, the nominees for Best VR AR game. And the Game Award
what
goes
are you to RE4?
Resident Evil 4 VR.
Of course they are. RE4.
And finally, your most anticipated game presented by Prime Gaming.
Breath of the Wild is
here
gonna win.
The nominees.
Breath of the Wild is probably gonna win.
And the Game Award Art. Goes to Elden Ring for the second year in a row. All right, well, everyone, our next guest is a little shy. If anyone in the audience has any twin blades or wing spears, I'm talking to you, Reggie, I'm going to ask that you please put those away for now. Let's bring him out here. He's a little shy, but look, everybody, it's my pot friend. Come on out, pot friend.
What the hell is
great
that?
Great to see you. You should put a bow tie on or something. Come on out, pot friend. Don't be shy.
What the hell is
looks
that?
Looks like he's got a note or something. You got a note there, pot friend? Yeah, all right. Let's see. Let's see what this note says. Thanks, pot friend. Good evening. Please enjoy my gift. A new trailer for Elden Ring.
Let me see what the hype is about this, because everybody and their mother, they always be saying Elden Ring, Elden Ring. Let me
Elden Ring, Elden Ring.
Let me see what the hype is about here. I want to understand. I want to get it.
Bandai Namco.
It happened an age ago. But when I recall, I see it true. On a night of wintry fog, the rune of death was stolen. And the demigods began to fall. Starting with Godwin the Golden.
Oh boy. About to make you uncomfortable real quick.
Queen Mariko was driven to the brink. The The shattering ensued, a war that wrought only darkness. The Elden Ring was broken. But by whom? And why?
The hell? Yeah, next Dark Souls slash Bourne game.
Like Lord of the Rings.
Lord
Bloodborne.
And yeah, people, them Bloodborne Souls type games, I know people go ape for. Completely berserk.
The Conqueror of the Stars, General Odar.
I mean, I like the animation, but that ain't game.
Yeah.
And the blade of Mikkel and Melania the Seventh. These two were the mightiest to remain, and locked horns in combat.
Didn't they have a beta that only some people were able to get into for this game? Or am I thinking of another game? Like a few weeks ago or something, right? Or am I tweaking? I feel like it. I feel like I heard something about that. I don't know. I could be mistaking it for another game, though. Wow, look at that luscious hair.
And so, we inhabit a fractured world. Awaiting the arrival of the Elden Lord. Unless, of course, thou shouldst take the crown.
What the hell? Her face is... Yeah. Elden Ring. There you have it.
I'm still in between.
Yeah, I feel like there was a beta or something that was like only for like content creators that were big or something. But I don't know if it was that game.
Good. Just confirming the date. The same. February.
Oh, it comes out February. Does it?
Amazing. I can't wait to step deeper into the world of Elden Ring when it does come out in February. Tonight, we've teamed up with Spotify to reveal what you're listening to every day on gaming consoles as part of Spotify's Wrapped. So what were the most listened to songs in 2021 on gaming surfaces? Here are the top three. Rapstar by Polo G, Montero by Lil Nas X, and Mood by 24K Golden featuring Ian Dior. Congratulations, and make sure to make your Spotify Wrapped tonight. Stick around, because coming up, Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss reveal The Matrix Awakens. We debut a brand new next generation game, and the Game Awards Orchestra pays tribute to our Game of the Year nominees.
Okay. Bang, bang, bang. All right, so I know people are hyped about that freaking Elden Ring release date, huh? Well, I mean, if the game looks cool, I'll probably try it out.
Go ahead and break off, old timer. You don't think
we shall see. I mean, I'll probably get bodied off. Completely. Never break, but you know.
Rule two. Oh, you're one of them. I've got all day, baby.
Break off. You know you want to.
Never.
Oh, damn. Genshin said, hey guys, we won best mobile game. We're going to give out 1600 Primo. They're giving out a free 10. Genshin? Giving out a free 10.
Didn't breathe them for so long.
What?
I just never knew that it could be a job that I could be good at.
Oh, wow.
You almost made me choke on my water, though.
Oh my god. Somebody said banger tweet, and then Genshin tweeted, yes, Genshin do be like that. They typed Genshin there. So they're aware. They're aware of what happened.
If you're a minority working in a game,
God.
You can't go through
life. See, whoever's running this Genshin Twitter account now, they need to just keep running it, okay? I hate when they're all robotic and stuff. Give me somebody that's actually running it that will make jokes.
Lunar Break is aimed at underrepresented people working in the UK game industry.
I was wondering if you can help me out.
Let's take stock. I feel like
people just really want to be connected and be a part of the community.
Let's go. I'm happy about that. So we're actually gonna get a free 10 pull. Let's go. No matter what Ido is gonna be
the fear track to play some Resident Evil 4. I am terrified but excited.
Let's
Ah!
And they got her in a box play. Oh my god. They got her in a box playing RE4 and then, oh god, what the hell?
Oh, that is just too realistic.
yes. They canceled the Cowboy Bebop freaking Netflix show, the live action. But yeah, I'm very surprised that freaking Genshin is giving us... Oh, there's your Breath of the Wild too. I'm very surprised that Genshin's giving us a 10-pull though. That's like winning the lottery for us. That is legit. Winning the...
Have they learned the lesson?
Yeah, they have.
Hey, Bea.
That's freaking crazy. Genshin, you're making good... You're making a good idea. Good plan. Oof. It's still going on?
Isn't that the Discord remix?
Dude, I don't know. What's up, Nate? How you doing? Genshin's giving us a free 10 pull because we got Genshin to win best mobile game.
Mm-hmm.
Big poggy.
What in the world?
What are they showing? Is it showing something new or? I was still looking at my phone. Pre-order's gonna go crazy. But there's been a lot of good game announcements today.
Yeah, there's a lot.
He sacrifices cash to FromSoft while sighing, I'm a sucker. I mean, hey, everybody has their games they like. Everybody has their games. Yeah, free 10 pull, indeed. They'll be giving us the primos. I have to look again at their official tweet. Yeah, from December 11th to December 14th, we'll be getting primos for it, so. Pretty pog. Not with my luck, it still sucks. Listen, you never know. You might win a 50-50. I've won two 50-50s.
Hi, everybody. My pick hey, Vo, you should ask Cantor to play Genshin.
Yeah, you want to play some Genshin, Nate? Genshin? You like it? You just woke up? Oh, yeah, you missed the Sonic trailer, Suicide Squad gameplay.
That was a look at which Sonic Game of the Year nominees video, YouTube creators yeah, and Sonic fans want to see win later games, tonight. We'll find out if they are right when we present Game of the Year. Every year at the Game Awards, we try to find games that push the medium forward in new and unexpected ways. This game comes from Embark Studios in Sweden, a new team of veteran developers. Their first game brings together thrilling multiplayer PvE action, a next-generation physical sandbox, and incredible visuals to create a truly dynamic player experience. Here's the reveal, complete with real gameplay.
You said, what happened? There's been a lot of announcements tonight. You have to look them up, because there's a bunch of stuff. They're pretty good. This year's Game Awards was definitely better than last year's Game Awards, I'll say that. Last year's was, oh god.
There is no way to hide.
The lady keeps showing up.
That lady need to stay away. I know what you're talking about.
We give them different names, but they're all the same. Killing machines falling from the sky.
Killing machines?
This is our home. Our bastion of resistance. This is where the brave meets the bold.
What do you say? Is there any good mobile game shown? Genshin Impact.
We will face our fears head on. Showtime.
I don't know about his audio. Hey! actually, once I realized there was an actual song going on, I'm like, that's probably a copyrighted song. No, no. Yeah, Genshin Impact. Yeah, buddy. We big hype out here. So what's going on in this game? What is even happening?
Killer robots invading.
Killer robots. Okay. Gotcha. Oh my gosh.
Oh my god, it's a spider mech. As always.
Yeah, how many freaking spider mechs are we gonna see today? Freaking spider mech city. Wow. That's a nice spider mech.
Hey, it's the spider mech from Avengers.
Oh no. Don't remind me of that. Anything but that thing. That was so bad. Is it done?
Breaking orbit. Southern Rust Belt.
They will never stop coming.
Oh my god. That is crazy. Oh no.
Marks on screen, calling for volunteers. Enlist. Resist.
Okay. All right, well, they're about to give us the game of the year, right? Okay, shut up. I thought you were done with your freaking music. You want to keep going? You want to keep showing me the screen longer?
That was incredible.
Game of the year time.
Now
let's
we
see
have
it.
Two special guests joining us for a very special moment. Carrie Ann, Keanu, welcome.
Oh,
I'm sure you guys recognize this iconic scene moment, right?
Jeff, thank you. It's good to be here at the Game Awards, and yes, this is one of the scenes that made The Matrix feel so groundbreaking, and perhaps inspired a few video games, too.
Impressive.
Thanks.
Can you still do that?
Absolutely not. But I can, in the Unreal Engine 5. I believe everyone here is expecting to see something new, so here's a never-before-seen look at The Matrix Resurrections, exclusively for the Game Awards. 2021! Let's roll the clip.
Okay.
The Matrix Resurrections looks awesome, and we can't wait to watch it on December 22nd. But getting back to tonight's theme, which is the world of interactive entertainment, I have to say, Keanu, you've been in several great video games and immersive experiences. Did you ever think that one day a game could look as real as being in the Matrix?
Absolutely. I mean, we are reaching the point at which the line between the physical and virtual worlds are blurry.
And with interactive storytelling reaching stunning levels of fidelity, maybe it's fair to ask,
he's still moving
what
his
is
hands.
A game? What is a movie?
Over 20 years ago, The Matrix pushed the boundaries of filmmaking and visual effects. We couldn't have imagined where the state of the art would be today with photorealistic digital humans in virtual sense.
To push the limits, once again, we decided to team up with Epic Games.
And now we are proud to bring you tonight's final world premiere at the Game Awards 2021! A glimpse of The Matrix Awakens. An Unreal Engine 5. Experience.
Oh my god. This dude. Alright. Well, let's see.
Oh, Matrix.
Yeah, like I said, never watched the movies.
I'm Thomas Anderson. Like many of you, I work with computers.
But computers, is this a game?
Are also mirrors. Reflecting back who and
it is
they said an experience.
You still got it.
Like riding a bike, they say.
I mean, it looks crazy. Visually, though, it looks. Download now. Go to the Matrix.
Nice.
Oh yeah, it's playable. Everything you just saw is running in real time in Unreal Engine 5 on PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X and S. It is pretty mind-blowing. And now you can download and experience The Matrix Awakens for yourself for free right now in its entirety. It's available right now. Make sure to play it. It is mind-blowing. Epic is just taking things to another level. Play it tonight, please. As we look to the future of games with platforms like Unreal Engine 5, it's now time to celebrate the best games of this year. To present Game of the Year, please welcome last year's winner of Game of the Year and Best Game Direction from Naughty Dog, Neil Druckmann.
Ah, The Last of Us 2. Yeah, the game that won every award last year.
Thanks, Jeff. Man, it feels awesome to be back here together in person. Congratulations to everyone who managed to release a game this year. Perseverance, dedication, and passion are inspiring, and there's no shortage of that in this room. Now, performing music from each of tonight's Game of the Year nominees, once again, the Game Awards Orchestra.
All right, so, ladies and gentlemen, who are we giving this to? Are we giving it to Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart, which I feel like I would not be mad if it gets Game of the Year. It sort of deserves it, honestly. It is Game of the Year material, but will it win? I don't think so. And I think it should have won a, like, best looking game or something like that. But did Kenna win
direction.
It? Art Direction, yeah. But freaking Deathloop somehow won that, I think.
I don't know how.
I don't know how that happens. Or is it, It Takes Two, will it win? I heard good things about this game. I don't think it wins Game of the Year, though. You don't know how Ratchet and Clank will do due to the other awards? Yeah, unfortunate. Because Ratchet and Clank was ridiculously good. I don't think this game wins, no. Now, Psychonauts 2. This, very underrated from what I understand. I don't think this wins either, though. Yeah, so I've heard about It Takes Two, so I've heard. They're going crazy.
They're mixing up music.
I think this is the game that wins.
I'm yeah.
Pretty sure this game's gonna win. Sure. This likely gonna win. I mean, it I had a good time with the game.
Ethan Winters.
Yeah, I think Resident Evil Village wins. That's my guess. But there's gonna be DLC coming to that game.
Wait, is
it? Now, yeah, there is. Now, Dread. Dread deserves Game of the Year, and I wouldn't be mad. I would not be mad. It's just one of those years that, man, there's just games in here that they all deserve it, you know? They really do.
There's only three games that I want in Game of the Year. If it's not of those three, I'm gonna be pissed.
Yeah, has to be one of those three. We just saw freaking Dread. Village. You've been playing RVA.
I've been playing.
For some reason, I'm now getting a bad feeling that Deathloop's gonna win.
Don't
like,
you dare.
Like, I have a bad gut feeling. I could be
Don't
wrong.
Don't you dare.
I have a bad gut feeling that Deathloop is gonna sneak in and take it. But I'm gonna have more faith in the Resident Evil people. I'm gonna have more faith in them. People that voted Resident Evil. I'm gonna have a lot of faith. Alright, here we go.
A moment of
will
truth.
It be? Will it be Deathloop, Psychonauts 2, Ratchet and Clank, Metroid Dread? In the Game of the Year. Go ahead, Neil. Read it. I'd be so surprised if Ratchet wins, but I don't think so. Very good music, as always.
Don't be Deathloop.
That was fantastic. A fitting way to honor the very best of the year. Let's hear it one more time for the Game Awards Orchestra.
My guy was trying to cross, but he had a weak. Okay.
And finally, congratulations to all of tonight's nominees. All pretty incredible games. And the 2021 Game of the Year is... It Takes Two.
Wait, what? What?
I knew the game was good, but so what?
I was up in the Dead Stage 2017, saying fuck the Oscar, and now, actually, in a way, the Oscars got fucked because the game was
getting way better. I know it's emotional and all, but.
It beat Resident Evil Village, Metroid Dread. It beat Deathloop.
And also, I want to say also I want to give this award to my daughter Mio and my soon-to-come daughter Zoe. It's so nice to have children. I'm surprised how much you love them. If you don't have children, go get them. I mean,
if you don't have children, go get them.
Thank you again. I'm shaking. Look at me, man. This is like a big, big moment for
that...
me. Anil, you're a big inspiration. Thank you.
Oh, that's insane. I know the game was really good. Like, I don't want to discredit the game at all. I know it did very well. But
you're a competitor.
How did it beat Metroid Dread?
Joseph Ferris, so amazing.
Or Resident Evil.
What do you think of the winners tonight? Did your favorite game win or not? Post your thoughts with a YouTube short and let us know who.
The way that I feel
tonight.
About that is like.
Thank you again for watching the Game Awards.
I think that surprised me more than God of War actually managing to win Game of the Year that year. I mean, God of War definitely deserved the year that it won, but I thought it wasn't gonna win. Holy crap. Oh yeah, no, I know it's a good game, but the fact that it beat Dread and freaking Resident Evil and even Deathloop is crazy to me. And I say that from like a popularity standpoint on how like popular those games were. That is genuinely surprising. Holy crap. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. The games that we thought were gonna win for Game of the Year, it did not win. What the
heck? Hey, it wasn't Deathloop.
Yeah, it wasn't Deathloop. It wasn't Deathloop, but damn, I was not expecting that. That was like a complete swerve. That felt like when you remember that year that Sekiro won Game of the Year? It feels like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember when Sekiro won Game of the Year, guys? And we were all like, huh? I was like, huh? I'm like, I know the game was good, but what?
Nani?
Damn, bro. That's insane. I already know Twitter is going to be blowing up. Dread didn't win Resident Evil. Listen, guys. Miss Damitres, she won for best voice actor, okay? So we're good. We all won, okay? We're fine. Nintendo left us high and dry this year. They said, yeah, take this montage, buddy. Sonic did his thing this year. That was good. This year's Game Awards was better than last year. I enjoyed it. There was a lot of ads that were sort of like, But other than that, it was good.
They should have given at least one award to Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, Ratchet and Clank got done. Ratchet and Clank got Spider-Man'd. What happened to Ratchet and Clank is exactly what happened to Spider-Man. Spider-Man did insane. Like, it was an incredible game, but it got, like, zero awards because it was up there going against, like, Breath of the Wild, wasn't it? Persona 5. God of War, Persona 5, Breath of the Wild. I think that was the year that it was going up against that crap for Spider-Man. Spider-Man just came out the wrong year. It's like that. But, yeah. I don't know how Ratchet & Clank didn't win, like, the art design, though. I don't know how Deathloop wins art design, but not Ratchet & Clank. Did have, like, Ratchet & Clank, the ray tracing, everything, the environment was great, but... Yeah, there was only a few awards here and there where I was like, I don't know what was going on. The rest of them, it seemed normal. But, yeah, I guess I'll see y'all for the next Game Awards next year, you know? A lot of good games coming out next year. It's going to be pretty crazy. Very stacked year. God of War, Bayonetta, freaking Elden Ring, Breath of the Wild 2, potentially. A lot more. You said, so did Genshin win Best Mobile Game of the Year? And if so, will they give us free pulls? Yes.
Oh,
they did
it's
win.
Not Genshin, it's Genshin.
Yeah, sorry, Genshin. Yeah, Genshin Impact won Best Mobile Game. game, and we're getting a free 10 pull. So within the December 11th to the 14th, they'll be giving us the free Primo Gems. So we're going to get a free 10 pull, to answer your question, which is pretty hype. I found that out on Twitter. I follow them on Twitter, so yeah. You said, yo, we're going to be 1v1 in that Persona 4 Arena next year? That's crazy. Yeah, I'm going to get Persona 4 Arena Ultimax or whatever, yeah. And the crazy
Are you going to main Adachi?
No, I'm not. The crazy thing is Persona, like Atlas and everything, they still have like, what is it, like 6 more announcements or something crazy that are going to be going into next year for their games. So I'm pretty sure one of them will be Persona 3. And then the very last announcement, like I keep saying, at the end of next year will be Persona 6 getting announced. So yeah, you said now it's Genshin. Yeah, because the lady that announced the Genshin winning, she said Genshin Impact. So now everybody's just memeing, even the Genshin Twitter account memed about it.
Yeah, it's basically trending right now.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, other than that, thank you, Rez, for watching this with me. It was fun. It was very, very fun. And thank you guys for watching in chat. Yeah, Persona 6 next year Game Awards? I think so, honestly. Because they're spacing out these announcements. Yeah, Atlas, they still have a bunch more announcements to go going into next year. So it's going to be cool. But yeah, be sure to like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. I'll see you guys tomorrow. We'll see what we're doing. And other than that, stay safe, and as always, don't do crack. Jimmy, hit that outro, and let's get the music playing, please.
Where's my goodbye kiss?
Excuse you? You ain't talking. You must be talking to chat. I know you ain't talking to me. I know damn well you ain't talking to me.
Give me a smooch.
Nah, bruh.